All right. Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News. This is the pseudo snort report. You know what the situation is. Let's stop all the talking and get to the talking. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here to talk about Kiwi's conspiracies, or Kiwispiracies as they call it. DSP apparently felt the need to debunk some of these claims that are made against them. Now, we all know, if going off of the 6 years or 7 years debunking stream that he did some years ago, coming off of the pro-Jared debacle, that he doesn't really debunk much of shit, but I thought it'd be funny, something to kind of help you guys get along with your day, and, you know, who doesn't deserve a good laugh at Darkside Phil's expense, right? Right? Right. So let's go ahead and get into the situation, and I will lay out more details as it comes along. Make sure that you guys are continuing to support your local Snortbucks Coffee Company, because it's the best beverage company. And I'll see you guys literally in just a second. Enjoy. Devour. Holy shit. He's such a... Okay, real quick, before I get you into the title and all the nonsense that that entails. I don't even have to be sure. I know you guys have friends and family you've gone out to dinner with, right? Or you've had family dinners with, or whatever the case may be. How many of you really can say that you guys have a relative who eats like this or reacts like this? You know what I'm saying? And believes that it's normal. And that's really kind of one of the problems with Darkside Phil, with this whole DSP tries it or feasting with the king, is that the reactions he gives, he believes is normal, or he believes is what people expect to see from him. But since he doesn't have anything to really draw upon, because I'm really of the theory that he eats alone, that him and Catherine just eat in separate rooms. He displays what he believes, what he wants to see, or what he would expect to see, which makes it even worse, which is why, ladies and gentlemen, that it's never a good thing to be a fucking hermit. It's never a good idea to shield yourself from the world, except for when you're trying to basically fleece money from people. That's the overall problem. It's a sad situation, to say the very least. Anywho, let me see if I can bring this back to at least right there, and let's go ahead and make the proper introductions, shall we? Ladies and gentlemen, we are here with Hate Army Watch. Big ups. let's see, Darkside Phil debunks Kiwispiracy theories and devours Five Guys. This is from August 14th of 2021. The link will be down in the description. Well, sorry. Hate Army published this on the 15th, but the video, but the source material is from the 14th. The link will be down in the description. Oh boy. So let's get into the madness. Oh, wait a second. Hold up. There we go. Just want to make sure. I might change that color though, too. Oh, that font. I love the font, but I think it's good for what Hate Army's doing. I just think I need to change the color. Or I could have it darker at the top and lighter at the bottom. That might help it show better. I'll speak with someone on that. I think I can get that worked out. Anywho, let's go ahead and get started. Here we go.
Oh, dude. The FBI have to me $20 and they said that they're watching me. Sounds great. I like to be watched. Especially by the FBI. It's amazing. I don't know why you would watch me. I certainly have never done anything in my life to ever warrant FBI attention. Okay. Oh, that's delicious. Yum, yum, man. Jalapeno. Man, that's good.
just such an awkward individual. He really is. It's even though I am the last person to show any type of empathy or sympathy to this individual, I can, to some degree, I can understand to some degree why people would feel compelled to help him. He comes across as a very pathetic individual, a pathetic, miserable individual, someone who had no self-worth, had no value to life, nor to bring any value to life. And once he found something that people gave him some type of acknowledgement, or he ended up getting some type of positivity from, to his own self-benefit, of course, he just stuck with it. Which is a shame, because at the end of the day, instead of it being, oh, this is good for me, this makes me feel good about myself, let me continue to make content to hopefully have other people who may be going through what I'm going through, you know, be able to feel the same. Instead, he just kept only focusing on himself. And then he got mad that it all fell apart and people went away and never came back. Then he got mad that he got all this attention from all this negativity and it stuck with him. Because that's really what he's resentful for. He, initially when he started this, it was all kinds of positivity for him. And he benefited so much. The majority of that is gone. I dare say all of it's gone. And now all it is quote unquote, the criticism, the negative reactions, the consequences of all of my years past decisions. And it won't go away. And they won't allow, and none of them are stupid enough to see me the way I want them to see me. And that's the reason why he's at where he's at now. It's absolutely amazing. It absolutely is fucking amazing. But since the guy had no self-worth of his own, how could you expect him? I'm kind of contradicting myself here a little bit, and answering my own question. How could someone who had no self-worth be able to instill having self-worth into others? Darkside Phil is the perfect example of that. He's on record for saying, if it wasn't for YouTube, he wouldn't feel like he did anything positive or had any value to his life and didn't contribute to anything, not even society, just anything, in any type of positive way. If it wasn't for YouTube, he wouldn't have found any meaning in his life. YouTube did that. So in some ways, how could you expect an individual like this? How could you expect a ghoul like this to be able to instill self-worth into others? And remember, Phil's the one who started that positivity bullshit, not us. He's the one who wanted the wave of positivity and all that nonsense. But he's not a positive person himself. He wants that to rain upon him, but he doesn't know how to essentially rain that onto other people. All he knows is how to piss on people and piss off people. It's very, very hard to pull a positive out of a negative. But when you have someone who's only negative, right? How could you expect them to do anything positive? How could you expect them to instill and motivate positivity in others if he doesn't know how to do it in himself? Something to think about. Poison to sit ball. Here and think, for him to sit there and think that that had value is insane. Which just goes to show, what I was trying to say. All he cares about is himself. That's all he's ever done. But in turn, he expects people to care about him. He expects people to give a shit about him. He expects people to just give him shit merely to exist. Merely because he exists. And he wonders why everything that's ever stepped into his life has eventually stepped out of his life. That every person that he may or may not have been cool with at one time or another were able to leave him with little to no regret. And some of them were praised. You know what I'm saying? Some of them were praised for leaving him. That's wild. I think amongst locals, I think DSP, for him always wanting to be unique in a snowflake, I think amongst locals, he is rather unique in that way. Or there's aspects of him, I should say, that makes him unique amongst locals, Which is kind of interesting because every lol cow is unique in their own way. But I think even DSP stands out. I think even DSP stands out when it comes to that.
Wow.
This is hilarious. It says, how do you ask for $7,800 monthly but still need raise? Still need fund raise? First of all, he can't even speak English. It's all broken English. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in life, all right, there's things called expenses and bills, all right? I have a mortgage, I have a car payment, I have insurance on multiple different things like my home and my car, I have health insurance, I have utilities, I have food costs every week, you know? I have all these things that normal people have, all right? When I was a full-time streamer on Twitch, these things were not an issue.
How many people do you guys know who have $7,800 in monthly expenses? And still need more on top of that, that aren't living in houses, in large houses by that notion. You know what I'm saying? Not living in some shitty little fucking condo, middle section condo, I should say, or townhouse if you want to give him a little bit more credit. You know what I'm saying? Who's driving a 2017 vehicle? Like, you know what I'm saying? Who's overpaying for a lot of stuff because he's too stupid to do research and or he's too lazy or too stupid to go ahead and negotiate down some of his costs. But $7,800 isn't enough because I'm a mature adult with expenses. Jesus, let's continue.
I was making enough on Twitch to afford everything easily. And
let's bring that back real fast. I was making enough to afford everything on Twitch easily. Let's hear that.
That normal people have. All right. When I was a full-time streamer on Twitch, these things were not an issue because I was making enough on Twitch to afford everything easily. And the problem
now, keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, when he was on Twitch, right? So I want you to take you guys back to 2020. And beginning of 2021, overdraft fees, late fees, couldn't afford money for supplies for Jasper. Didn't have enough money to go out to take him for him and his wife to go out and get a nice meal. Could barely afford groceries. Wasn't sure if he would be able to make his utility bills on time. Do I need to keep going? Do I really need to keep going? While he was on Twitch, while he had YouTube as a secondary income, while he still had PayPal, while he had, Patreon, while people were donating to him on Patreon, on PayPal behind the scenes, but we were making all of our bills on Twitch easily. Let's go back and talk about how, oh, I need to raise this money for my taxes. I need to raise this money for my back taxes. I thought I had enough money, but I don't because this mysterious expense came up out of nowhere. So I really need to come up with this $1,200, this $1,300, this $1,500. Hey guys, I need you guys to continue to support this Vest Streak because I have all of these expenses and bills coming up that is related to my taxes and to my bankruptcy. And I really need to come through with you guys to really come through and help me out with this. Because if not, if I don't pay them, I don't know what's going to happen. Does anybody remember any of this? But we were paying all of our bills easily on Twitch.
That, you know, with the years of debt that had piled up, I made bad decisions in regards to debt and accruing debt and debt management. And also the fact that my income had gone down multiple times over the years because of trolling activities. And also on top of all that, tax issues screwed me over because I'd been doing my taxes wrong for 3 years since I moved here, and I was backloaded on like tens of thousands of dollars of taxes that I was supposed to be paying to the state that I didn't pay because my accountant at the time was doing everything wrong. Okay.
Wait. Did he say tens of thousands of dollars and back state tax? Excuse me. Let me hear that again.
When I was a full-time streamer on Twitch, these things were not an issue because I was making enough on Twitch to afford everything easily. And the problem was that, you know, with the years of debt that had piled up, I made bad decisions in regards to debt and accruing debt and debt management. And also the fact that my income had gone down multiple times over the years because of trolling activities. And also on top of all that, tax issues screwed me over because I'd been doing my taxes wrong for 3 years since I moved here. And I was backloaded on like tens of thousands of dollars of taxes that I was supposed to be paying to the state that I didn't pay because
tens of thousands of dollars that he owed in back state tax. That's what he just said. Tens of thousands of dollars that he owed in back state tax. Even though I think the theory is that he didn't have to pay nearly that much. Interesting. Also, as it pertains to all the money he lost throughout trolling, he was getting quote unquote pay cuts from Machinima way before 2015. When he ended up fucking himself over by deleting all of those videos off of King of Hate, off the King of Hate vlogs and DSP Gaming. He did that to himself. That was a self-inflicted wound that he did. So that doesn't count. That doesn't count at all. And then all the pay cuts and everything he got on Machinima, it was because his viewership was dropping. That's why he essentially had to beg them in 2014 to not give him late 2013, I should say. He begged Machinima basically not to give him a pay cut because he was moving in 2014. And he was like, hey, please don't, you know, drop my income any further because I'm making this move. And when I make this move, all of these things are going to happen I'm going to have the chance to do all this new stuff with my content as well as introduce new things to my content. And I don't really want to take a hit. And the thing is, he knew that conversation was coming. That's why for one of the few times in his life, he was proactive into reaching out to Machinima before they actually reached out to him. And they were like, sure, no problem. All right, we'll keep you where you're at and hopefully you can make some changes. But he was already in a decline in views. In turn, is the reason why they, quote unquote, cut him as many times as they said. I say quote unquote because I'm not completely subscribed to the theory that all those things were pay cuts. I think there were some other issues. If, for example, just to give you guys a little bit of DSP lore, Machinima had early on, they had some issues, some payroll issues, if you will, not with actually paying people, with paying people too much. So it was like one or two particular months, Phil got these ridiculous paychecks from them. Absolutely enormous paychecks. Eventually payroll ended up figuring it out and they reached out to him and they're like, hey, we overpaid you this 1 or 2 months or whatever. So like, yeah, don't expect basically a paycheck next pay period or whatever, or next month or whatever the case may be. I can't remember exactly how they did it. But they balanced it out. And Phil, being Phil, probably was running through that money ruckshot because it was so much fucking money. He thought, oh shit, my next paycheck's gonna be just that big or even bigger. So fuck, let me go ahead and spend this shit and do whatever I want to do with it. And I think that's what he did. And then they had to come to him and be like, yeah, you're probably not gonna get a paycheck next period because we overpaid you by a lot. By a whole lot. And I think Phil even said, oh, okay, well, that makes sense. Understand. That's understandable. So I'm not completely subscribed to the theory that they were just like, that all of the pay cuts that they gave him were pay cuts. But that's neither here nor there. But yet again, just to give you guys another idea of his situation. But the main point is, we owe tens of thousands of dollars in back state tax. He didn't say federal. He said back in business and occupation tax, or state business and occupation tax, I should say. So keep that in mind.
This issue screwed me over because I'd been doing my taxes wrong for 3 years since I moved here, and I was backloaded on like tens of thousands of dollars of taxes that I was supposed to be paying to the state that I didn't pay because my accountant at the time was doing everything wrong, okay? I say accountant is really a tax attorney. So all those things.
Does anybody remember around that time when he was going from the guy who prepares my taxes to my tax preparator to my tax attorney to my CPA? He kept jumping around because people kept throwing these different terms at him or these different, all these different terms for all these different people who work within that field. And he just kept bouncing around with those names, with these different names or titles, I should say. He couldn't actually stick with one of them. It was kind of funny how that was going on, too. It makes you wonder if he was actually really speak into anyone at all. Because clearly he knew what he was doing. He knew that he owed business and state occupation tax and he just wasn't paying it. He made sure Panda was paying hers, but he wasn't paying his and he knew that he owed money. And yet he's still blaming that guy for all that bullshit, which is even more funny and ironic because it's very, if the story's correct, the guy he's shifting all this blame to is a family friend of his. It's a family friend of his parents, I should say, who was doing his taxes in Connecticut. Which means what, ladies and gentlemen? Either the person was actually doing his taxes on the cheap, or they were doing it for free. And I don't think if anybody's actually come to that realization. Hold on a second. So think about it this way. Let's say that your dad, right, or your father or mother, whoever, knows a guy who does taxes and they've been doing their taxes for a number of years or whatever. And they're like, hey, my kid, he's, you know, he's moved on to another job. He's probably been doing Phil's taxes since the beginning anyway, if not his father was doing it. But let's say the guy was like, hey, you know, my son's gone on to do some independent work or whatever, you know, video creation or whatever the case may be. And he's making a lot of money. Would you mind looking over his taxes? You know, make sure he's doing his taxes right. Yeah, sure. You know, don't even worry about paying me. Just go ahead and just have your kid send the information over. Have little Philip shoot the information over to me. I'll take care of it. No problem. Or, yeah. Go ahead and have him send it over to me, man. I'll do it for cheap. Or you know, you need me to do your taxes this year anyway, right? I'll just bundle it all into that. Don't even worry about it. So all those years he was bitching and complaining about the taxes that he was having to pay. And he was saying, oh, I got to pay so much to actually get these taxes done. In truth, it's possible that he didn't have to pay anything. That this guy was paying all of his taxes. This guy was preparing his taxes and not charging him, I should say. Now, this is where it's going to kind of come in and be important. When Phil makes that move, right? And the guy is like, hey, you know, I'll go ahead and continue to do your taxes if you want, or you can find another tax preparator out there for you. Well, in Phil's head, well, you've already been doing my taxes. You already know what to expect. In Phil's mind, he's thinking, well, you're not charging me anyway. You've been doing my taxes for free for years. So why the fuck would I want to come out here and pay somebody when I could just have you continue to do it? He's not dumb enough to tell somebody this, but this is what he's thinking. And I think that's what the situation may or may not have been. Who could say? There's still theories floating around that he doesn't even owe, you know, business and state occupation tax. I'm pretty sure it's kind of proven at this point, but even still, that's still a theory that's floating around as well. So make of that what you will. But that's my initial thoughts. But remember, tens of thousands of dollars in back state and business occupation tax.
Over the years, okay? Added up to a situation where basically I couldn't afford my stuff anymore and I had to declare bankruptcy last year, all right? Now, before bankruptcy, I had credit. If I had a month where things were bad or slow, I guess that is the rep contest site, isn't it? I guess. I could fall back on credit to help me out, all right? That was a long time ago. Now I don't have credit or anything like that anymore. It's all gone. That's how it works is you declare bankruptcy, you're 10 years. You have no credit. You have nothing. Okay? So essentially, the only money I have is what I make on stream. That's it. What you see me make on
stream. Now, let's talk about a little. You know what I'm saying? Let's talk a little bit about that. Let's talk about the credit. So this idiot, if he was having a bad month, whatever that means, I'll put all my expenses, everything on my credit card. Okay, fair enough. So when you have a better month, or better months later on down the line, why didn't you just pay your credit cards off? Why were you only making the minimum monthly payments on those things and that's it? Think about that for a minute. Let's say you have a credit card that has $10,000 on it. You have a bad month, so you charge $3,000 onto it. Then next month you have an amazing month. Phil, instead of paying off the $2,000 or $3,000 he had to charge to cover for that bad month, he'll just go ahead and continue to pay the minimum monthly on it and that's it. And keep and pocket the rest of it and splurge it on whatever. That's why he had all that credit card debt. Because this idiot, because that's what he is, he's an idiot, was okay with spending these people's money and paying it back when he felt like it. And then when he really, really, really needed that money, he didn't have it. Because past Dark Side Phil fucked up future Dark Side Phil. It's like that. And that's why people like him shouldn't have credit. And when they do have credit, they usually fuck it all up anyway. But that's why people like him shouldn't have credit. That's why people like him should only live off cash, because then they may actually understand and may learn better financial management, to be honest. Or he could just get off his fucking ass and go to the bank and actually have someone walk through his expenses with him and help him form a budget. Because he clearly doesn't know how to budget. He clearly doesn't understand it. Mr. Business degree. Mr. I want to have a brick and mortar one day. Clearly, this is above his understanding. So maybe that's not something we should be trying to shoot for. Which he's not. He says that he's more than likely to end up streaming for the rest of his life. That doesn't sound like someone to me who has any future plans or aspirations. I could be wrong. Wouldn't be the first time. But I don't think so. I don't think so. And that in any brick and mortar that he would start up, he would end up driving into the ground in a couple years. If even that long.
Income. But you have to understand that there's all these bills and things behind the scenes that I'm constantly paying. There's taxes you don't know about. There's fees. Oh, boy. Ooh. Spicy. Oh, man, that jalapeno was spicy.
Now, so anyway, I don't know if Hate Army did it with this intention, but this is what I'm starting to think. You're hearing about all of the issues, all his financial issues, right? And then we cut back to Phil eating, which one could make the correlation that that's where the majority of Phil's money goes, to self-indulgence. And I think that's the point of this video. It's obviously pretty subliminal, so to speak. It could be just two birds with one stone for Hate Army. Who could say? But let's be honest, he probably spends the majority of his money on already prepared food, because he puts his emphasis on it when he says it, over anything else, over even his business expenses, these same business expenses that he needs to keep the business going. His first intention is to shove food down his own gullet before even doing what he needs to do. It's always doing what I want to do. Which is the reason why his expenses are all jammed up in the first place. Amongst many. I just thought I'd throw it out there. It's probably pretty obvious, but still. It's still really entertaining nonetheless. And that, and you have Devour right here. That's just perfect timing.
To the point of what I'm saying here, okay? First of all, what you see me make is not what I make.
You know what? Now that I think about it, because I just said perfect timing. There's a Mike Tyson sound clip of him saying that. I should download that shit and use that. That would be fucking hilarious. Mike Tyson's like, perfect timing. In the Mike Tyson voice, that would be hilarious. I need to look for that.
You see me make every single month is not actually what I'm making streaming. What you're seeing is what people are attempting to contribute. It doesn't mean I keep all that. It doesn't mean there's not fees involved. It doesn't mean there's not chargebacks involved. I don't publicly talk about that stuff anymore because I feel like it's not something you guys want to hear about constantly. And quite frankly, it's not something that talking a lot about is going to really fix. You know what I'm saying? Like, if someone's charging me back, they're probably going to charge me back no matter what, and they're a bunch of dickheads. So for me, talking about it constantly is not really going to fix the issue. Now, for a while, it was such a bad thing that I actually had to have all these things in place, verify tips and all that. Luckily, it's not as big of a deal anymore. But essentially, what you see is not, there it is, Deadwind Cavern. What you see is not what you get. You know what I'm saying? It's very different. People want to over-exaggerate and everything about the income that I make. I don't make nearly as much as what you see me make on a stream. Especially when it comes to Super Chats and stuff. YouTube is taking cuts of all of that.
Yeah, but see, we all know what the cuts that they take. Same thing with tips, and same thing with the memberships and the gifted subs on Twitch and YouTube, respectfully. We knew what the fees were, and that's what people were judging on how much he was making. He neglects that part. He completely and totally neglects that part. Another thing that he kind of forgets as well is when he started this whole verified tips bullshit, right? And people started to come to the conclusion that he could find out who you were. And he inadvertently exposed that a couple of times. That was a deficit. Like, people were way more hesitant to give him money under those pretense. If anything else, I don't know if that can... if it could be, if it was charted by anybody. But I think maybe his Patreon might have gotten a bit of a boost around that time, because it seemed, not that it would seem any safer, I think, just donating to his Patreon, but it certainly probably seemed less of two evils than giving him money through a verified tip on stream. Being that, he doesn't even acknowledge people on Patreon anymore. He's given that all up because he doesn't have editing software that he can't put the initials of your name up. Which leads to my next point. If you guys remember when he used to do the Patreon crawl back in the day, there's people's full names on those Patreon crawls. You can still find it on the old weekend previews on the King of Hate vlogs. You can find people's full names up there. Like, whole fucking names. That's still a thing, too. And like I said, people might have felt more comfortable going to his Patreon and giving money there because he doesn't even acknowledge Patreon anymore. So if you really wanted to help Phil one particular month and you didn't want to donate to, you didn't want to tip him directly, which he's going to just splurge on WWE Champions or whatever else the next day, or later on that evening, I should say, you could just go ahead and donate to his Patreon and you have nothing to worry about. But then, yet again, that doesn't matter because you can find people's full names over there. There is very few people who actually used some type of handle, if you will, when it comes to shout-outs. There are people up there that have their full names. Full government names. So, womp womp.
No, I didn't make that. You don't know what I make. The truth is, no one knows what I made but me. I don't even know what I make until the month after when YouTube actually pays me. I have no idea what I'm going to make, okay? So, you say, Phil needs this much a month and blah, blah, blah. Just because you see that doesn't mean that I'm making that, okay? And behind the scenes, like I said, there's all these things. There's taxes and things that happen that reduce what I make. You may think I make a certain amount. I don't. Look at my lifestyle. Where do you see the, you know what I mean? Like, if I was making tons of money, ridiculous amounts of money, disposable income, don't you think that things would be a little better around here, right? Like,
no, I'm wearing clothes. Because you don't want to pay for any of it. Let me give you another example, some DSP lore. The green screen. Well, yeah, the green screen actually was paid by Patreon. Patreon supporters paid for that. The soundproofing, the microphone, the mixer, all that was paid by Patreon. Patreon paid for all that. DSP didn't come out of pocket for that shit. The 4K television that he's playing on, he didn't pay for that. So a positive contributor supposedly sent him that TV. Same thing with the PS4 Pro. He didn't pay for that. A positive contributor sent him that. Or they sent him the money for it. That story keeps fluctuating. What else can we say that? What else did people pay for? That Nintendo Switch. His initial one was a brick, or so he says. So he got his money back for that. And then someone sent him a new Nintendo Switch. So he didn't theoretically pay for that either. That was somebody else. So if he had all this money, or, you know what I'm saying, sitting around or whatnot, wouldn't things be better? Well, look at everything that you essentially have so far. You didn't pay for those things. Right? Look at your new Xbox, your new laptop. You supposedly, air quotes, didn't pay for any of that either. Someone else contributed it. Oh, well, they contributed because they knew I didn't have the money. Yet you still have the money to go out and take your wife. You still have the money to go out three times a day on your day off to go and eat. Maybe if you saved up for like a month, you would have been able to afford all those things. Oh, well, I work hard. I deserve a day off from my, opportunity to spend time with my wife on a day out. Not really. You guys could just stay home and cook and spend the day with each other, like most people do. You know, like people who save up for houses, right? Because they want to start a family. They have to make certain sacrifices to do it. And if they want to spend time with each other, right? That's one of the ways of doing it, Phil. You and Catherine could literally make food for a picnic and then go out to the park or some shit and have a nice picnic out. You could do those things. You chose not to. So that's your fault. That's your problem. You can try to argue semantics all you want, but that's really what it comes down to. And everybody knows that. Because, you know, a mature adult is expected to be responsible. you continue to act like some 12-year-old kid who wants to be taken out, or well, wants to spend a day with his mother and essentially run errands and be pampered. That's all it is. And you looked at begging as being the easiest way to accomplish that. Therefore, you choose to do it. It is what it is. Calling a spade a spade. Oh, well.
That I've owned for like 5 to 10 years, you know, but people are so dumb. They think that any dollar that you make is just pure spending money that immediately you can just go out and spend on whatever you want, right? No, that's not adult life. That's just not adult life. All right, it's not. And on top of all that stuff, okay, there's things in my life that you guys are not going to know about. I'm not going to tell you every single personal aspect of my life. I'm not going to tell you what every dollar needs to be spent on. Right now, I could concretely tell you there's things going on behind the scenes you guys have no idea about. I've never mentioned it. I don't feel like it's anyone's public business to know about it.
It doesn't matter. It's going to all come out eventually. But even then, I would assume, as most people already have, it's still frivolous spending, no matter what. And that's not adult life. So adult life is sitting up there looking like Mr. Fucking Potato Head and paying, what, $50 for fucking gunner glasses, $100 for the vest, and then $150 for a fucking hat? You literally sound like a fucking clown. Well, you are a fucking clown, to be honest. But that right there, that's being a mature adult. And then it's being a mature adult, ladies and gentlemen, to make $450, for example, on a stream, on the first stream, I should say, making only maybe $50 on the second stream, then showing and bitching the whole night about that, and then showing up the next day and getting mad, you know what I'm saying, that you only made $500 the day before, hitting both of the stream goals, though. Theoretically, the $450 he made on the first stream covers that entire day, and theoretically bleeds into the next day, but you still want to sit there and bitch about it the following day because, oh, no one supported the night stream. Well, Phil, you had $450 on the first stream. So what, dude? I need the tips goal to be hit every fucking stream. Phil, you made enough money to cover the night stream. No, dude, you don't understand. I have other expenses. I had things that pop up, and I need to make sure I make all the money that I can. That's being a mature adult? That's being responsible? Okay.
Cost me a lot of money, all right? But it's no one's business. Maybe one day I'll reveal that stuff to you, but the fact that so many people take everything that happens to me as a negative and spins it as a way to hurt me, why would I want to reveal more personal stuff to you guys, right? That's why I have this separation now between my work life and my private life. The less I reveal about what's going on privately, the less people can use it to potentially hurt me. So that's why I don't tell you guys everything anymore, okay? So I hope you understand that, right? If you like the content, support it. If you don't like the content, don't. If you think that I'm some kind of a liar and that I'm actually rolling in dough and I've got it off an offshore account somewhere, if you actually think that I'm stupid fucking enough to spend money on mobile games and all this other dumb shit instead of actually spending it on helping my family and having a better life, if you're that dumb, then don't watch the content and don't support it.
And that's the reason why people don't. And you using your family as a fucking shield is still pathetic as fuck. It really is. It's fucking pathetic. It really is. And the fact that you think you're so goddamn smart that sooner than later you're not going to end up divulging that information is insane. That's the whole reason why swine crafting or gout crafting or whatever, theory crafting is the actual physical term, but you know what I mean. That's the reason why gout crafting exists, because it's fun. And by taking what little information he gives you, which is not even little, it's really a lot of information when you really put it all together, you can formulate a pretty solid theory. Now, are some of those theories going to be a bit out there? Sure, absolutely. Are most of those theories still pretty bang on? Yeah, and even when he's been caught red-hooved, he still tries to bitch and complain about it. He still tries to shift blame instead of taking personal responsibility. How are you going to blame a detractor, troll, hater, or critic on how you spend your money? How does that work? And if this thing is your personal business, right? How are you going to blame a detractor, troll, hater, or critic on how it all fucked up or how the money got fucked up in a business that you supposedly own and run. When in actuality, you're nothing more than just a fucking employee. Someone cut you a check. Period. He streams for a living, right? Well, he begs for a living, but you know what I mean. He streams, right? He sits there and he sits to this fucking schedule, which makes no goddamn sense. And I think it's already been proven that he streams, what, twice the amount that the average streamer does? And yet he's nowhere nearly as successful. He's sitting here fighting for six figures while most of these people are in the sevens and growing. And he's doing everything he can to hold on to six figures, doing twice as much work, quote unquote. And his content's trash. He's being overpaid. He's certainly being overcompensated just to do what he's doing. But yet he has to work, quote unquote, twice as hard to get it. That's amazing. So yeah, he's pissing all of that money away. And the reason why is because he's pissed off that he doesn't have it as easy as everybody else. Oh, I wish I could just stream, you know, as often as I wanted to and still be paid properly for it. He probably could. To be honest with you, the night stream is unnecessary. To be honest with you, the day stream some days is unnecessary. There's no reason why Darkside Phil can't stream 4 or 5 hours a day and be done with it. And if you cut out all the bullshit pre-streams and everything, that's kind of what it rolls up into being anyway. But truth be told, there's no reason why he doesn't stream 4 hours a day and he wouldn't make the exact same amount, more or less. It's just going to consist of more begging in a smaller period of time. He might as well. And there's no need for him to stream 6 days a week. It's not helping anybody. Certainly not helping him. You want to know why he does it? Because he's fucking jealous and he's greedy and he's stupid. He looks at it as the more often he's streaming, the less opportunities that people who are part of his hardcore viewer base, the less opportunities that they have to give money to other people. If he's streaming, he automatically thinks he's the priority in their lives and they'll give the money to him. And I guarantee you, I'm almost pretty sure that's why he does it. That's why he does it. Because he sees all, when he was on Twitch, he saw all those emotes from other streamers that some of his people in his fan base used to put into his chat, and that shit used to piss him off. And I'm not talking about the wings emotes and other shit. I'm talking about there was emotes from like Dr. Loophole, from some of these other, back in the day, there was people used to drop Dr. Disrespect shit in his chat, and he didn't like it. He was smart enough not to say anything, but you could visibly look at him and see that he didn't like what he was seeing. So trust me, it definitely comes down to jealousy in some way, shape, or form when it comes to that shit. That's why he does it. And he's even more worse off because of it. Because he's jealous. Because he's stupid. Imagine you putting all that time in and not being anywhere close to successful, right? Than other people who do it in half the time. Some people do it even less than that. You got some big streamers out there who put in 15, 20 hours a week. You know what I mean? 15, 20 hours a week, if that. And can easily drum in, you know, $20,000, $30,000. DSP, it takes months for DSP to get that. It takes months for DSP to get that. Yikes.
Right? Why are you wasting time with someone who you think is a buffoon or you know, a liar? Why? But if you like the content, then come
because and show it's because that's entertaining, and that's the problem. What he does at his base level, in his base form, if you will, is not entertaining. When he's pissed off, when he's saying stupid shit, right? When he's doing stupid shit to make himself look even more stupid, that's where the entertainment value comes into play. And back in the day, people used to just clip it and that was it. And then, you know, make it in the videos or montages or whatever the case may be. Now, those people are actively contributing to the content, you know what I'm saying? To make him, to have him do it even more often. And that's what's pissing him off. But you're the adult, right? Because supposedly we're all just children. You're the adult. So why the fuck can't you, I don't know, exhibit some type of self-control to not do it so much? Or maybe just not do it at all. If it's really all about the love of the game, then shut the fuck up and play the game. And stop begging. Oh, but I have to beg. People need to know that I need help. Isn't that the point of the pre-stream? Hasn't he said in older pre-streams years back that, the pre-stream exists to let people know what I'm thinking and what I'm going through, and then when we get to the gameplay is just the gameplay. Even back then, he was lying to himself and to everybody else, but it's become even more prominent now.
If anything, I would hope that over the years, I have portrayed myself and been as honest with you guys as I can, that you guys know that I'm honest with you. You guys know that I'm not making shit up every day and I'm not spitting the truth, that I'm telling you the truth about that. What I need funds for today is to pay my fucking bills over the next couple days. If I can't pay them, they'll all be overdue, late fees associated with stuff, and then I'll be on the track to, you know, bad stuff. You know, it's that simple. It's just, people are just so ridiculous with these insane conspiracy theories that I can't possibly counter or answer any of them anymore. Because there's just, every day there's something new that's so ludicrous and over the top. I don't even know what the fuck people are talking about anymore. Right now, there's like five things. Every day I look at my Twitter. This ridiculous thing, this ridiculous thing, this thing about a viewer of yours, this thing about a moderator of yours, this thing about an application that you supposedly use, this thing about WWE champions, which never goes away, this thing about how you're lying to people and embezzling money, and this thing over here about this and that. And I'm like, I don't even know what the fuck anyone's talking about anymore. I don't pay attention to it. I don't. I literally don't pay attention to it. I just say,
I don't pay attention to it yet. I'm going to go ahead and raffle off essentially everything that's being said about me. On top of the fact that he knows that we have him dead to rights on the WWE champions. He knows it. He's not even, he doesn't even have the energy to try to even fight that off anymore. He knows he's been caught dead to rights. He knows that he got kicked out of those guilds or he left them on his own accord because the harassment was going to keep going. If he can't, let's call a spade, ladies and gentlemen. Let's be honest with each other for a minute. If Darkside Phil came out tomorrow and said, okay, guys, angry snort or angry sniff, I should say. That WWE Champions thing, yeah, it's mine. It's what I like doing in my spare time. Yes, I spend a portion of my tips doing that. It is what it is. What's going to happen? Let's be completely and totally honest with each other. What's going to happen? Out of 300 people, maybe 50 or 100 people are like, well, you lied to us, fuck you, we're out. And everybody else is just going to band together and be like, oh, well, it's okay, Phil, if you deserve to do what you want to do in your spare time. Well, why don't you start making videos on it, Phil? Why don't you do a stream on it, Phil, so we can see what's going on? Oh, well, I don't have a way to capture that. If I could find a way to capture it, then maybe I would consider doing that. And the detractors are going to be all over that bitch. All the people who watch detractor content is going to be all over that shit and laugh about that shit. And it's just another thing that's part of his legacy. But it's not going to end him, if you will. It's not going to do anything. The more he fights it, the worse it becomes. But once he admits it, it's what? Yes, he's going to lose some people. He may lose some people who don't even donate to him anyway. But he may lose some people who do throw money at him. And that's that. It's not going to end him. It's really not. It's becoming worse. It's the wound, if you will, is starting to fester and start to get infected because he's allowing it to. Instead of going to the doctor and getting that shit checked the fuck out, taking whatever shots that's needed, getting surgery if you need to get it, and get it onto the road to recovery, he doesn't want to admit that he's an addict. That's the first thing. And secondly, he doesn't want to be ridiculed or laughed at for it. Which, let's be honest, the latter is happening right now. The latter is still happening. He can't even escape that. And that's going to happen whether he admits it or not. The former should be more important. It's clearly a problem. It's clearly an issue. So if you're going to keep doing it, you might as well just come out and admit it. And yes, you'll probably get trolled in some of those groups anyway. You might even have to leave some of those groups. You're having to do that now anyway. So who gives a shit? But at least it's out there. At least you can own up to it. You're supposed to be the most honest guy on YouTube. But in actuality, it's not gonna end them. It's not gonna end them. WWE champions will forever be associated with Dark Side Phil. Here, let me see some. Let's see here. That right there is always gonna that right there is always gonna be the situation. He'll never be able to escape that. That's just the reality of it all. He's better off just coming out and just saying so. He's going to keep doing it. And people will, and believe it or not, there'll always be people who will support him for doing it. So, I mean, honestly, who gives a shit?
How fun we games. And if you support that content, do. And if you don't believe me, or you want every little personal answer, then don't come by and don't support and don't chill with me. It's fine. You don't have to. There's tons of other people out there who you can watch. And if that's the case, then go do it. But I'm grateful for everyone who does actually believe that I'm not some kind of crazy giant level scam artist person. Like, you're so crazy, the shit that people say. Do you not think that right now I'd like to do better for my family? Really? Like, I didn't get a honeymoon when I married my wife over 2 years ago. I don't get to do things for my family that would be nice. I don't get to improve my house.
All right, first things first. I didn't get a honeymoon with my wife. Well, first off, most people save up for their own honeymoons, Phil. That's not something that people are usually gifted as part of them getting married. But some do. So, you know, I'm just throwing it out there. But most people save for their honeymoons. First things first. Secondly, you had a chance to go on a honeymoon. You chose not to, remember? You chose to pocket that money because you couldn't afford to take the time off from work, air quotes, to actually go on that honeymoon, right? And so you couldn't afford to take the time off. And what else was the other excuse? Oh, and you really needed the money for your taxes. You really needed your money for that money for the taxes over the honeymoon. You chose that. So your mom said, okay, well, the money that we were going to give you for the honeymoon, here, go ahead and use it to put yourself back on that payment plan. And that's what you did, allegedly. So whose fault is it really, ladies and gentlemen, that he couldn't go on that honeymoon? Whose fault is it really that he couldn't go on that honeymoon? It was gifted to him. He chose to take the money in cash.
Around here that would make life better for us. Right now, we're in the midst of the hottest summer ever in Washington, and I have two air conditioners. I can't even cool the fucking house down enough so that we're not sweating profusely. Don't you think I'd like to be able to do better than that? Put central air in my house so we're not sweating disgustingly every fucking summer? Don't you think? Like, don't you think that's like the
natural thing? Well, first off and foremost, who's retarded enough to buy a house for the price point that you bought it for and not have central air in the first place? That's the first thing. That's what happens when you don't think ahead. Secondly, you've had plenty of opportunities since you've lived in that house to actually have central air put in or fixed, whatever the issue is. And he chose not to. Third, this is the same idiot who said, oh, we're going to move to Seattle because there's no reason it doesn't get hot in Seattle. So if I get a house out there that doesn't have central air, who gives a shit? It only gets up to 80 out there anyway. It rains most of the time. No big deal. His words, not mine. Womp womp. I really need to get some Archer sound clips in here too.
A man would like to do for his family, but you're so dumb. You're seriously so dumb that you believe conspiracy theories, that you'll believe every other negative piece of shit about me rather than the logical conclusion that Phil's not rich. That he's telling the truth, right? I just don't know anymore. So I don't, an idiot like this guy who's going to fucking do a super chat and accuse me of lying. Oh, you need this much a month. Fuck off. Just go away and never come back. No one cares about you, including me. I just want to enjoy the games, man, and have a good time with my audience. I don't need to put up with your nonsense, your accusatory tone, and your stupid conspiracy theories. Go wear your tinfoil hat with your circle-jerking group of losers on the fucking internet and have a good life. And leave me the fuck alone. I don't care about you. You know, I'm never going to convince these crazy people that what I'm saying is true, because they will always come up with another crazy thing to say. Seriously. Just, it's out of control.
So I like how he implies that, oh, I'll never be able to convince these crazy people that what I say is the truth because they'll just come up with something else, which feeds into the narrative that I've tried to convince these people I'm telling the truth and they still won't believe me. Yet we go into rant segments like this where he's trying to reaffirm a point to a group of people who don't give a shit and are just going to come up with another conspiracy on him later by his own pig logic. Isn't that crazy? And that's what I'm saying. These rants and all this bullshit isn't to try to keep the pay pigs in line. It's him trying to convince detractors. Because in actuality, that's what he's still fishing for. He's fishing for that handful of detractors who are willing to see something his way and hopefully come to his side. Because that's the problem, amongst many things, is he doesn't have, his voice doesn't mean shit. And he doesn't have anybody else who can articulate themselves well enough to argue for him. So he needs to try to basically put out his pig noses and hopes that someone would give him some type of sympathy and or empathy and come to his side and argue some of these points. That's one of the reasons why he reads Kiwi Farms, honestly. Because some of the fighting that happens over there, it's not even fighting, it's just debates. But some of the debating that happens over there, he feels like, okay, so there are some people that are at least trying to defend me at one time or another. The problem is at the end of the day, both parties are going to just turn around and laugh at him anyway. It doesn't matter. Which feeds back into what he's kind of saying where, well, even if they did take my side on something, it doesn't matter because they'll laugh at me for something else. Well, whose fault is it that there's something else to laugh at? Whose fault is that? You put your entire fucking existence, not even just his life, you've put your entire fucking existence online. You're really only a couple degrees. There's only a couple of degrees of separation between you and Chris Chan. There really is. There's only a couple of degrees. People essentially know everything about you. And if not, there's not too much that they couldn't find. You know what I'm saying? Like, people found Melissa, and you've already given the first name to three of your other cousins. It wouldn't take much to find them if they really wanted to. You know what I'm saying? It's not hard to track down the Burnell family tree. It wasn't hard enough for anybody to find your high school, to find out if you were really valedictorian or not. You know what I'm saying? It wouldn't be hard for someone to find your grades from college. Your whole life is an open book. And at the end of that book, ladies and gentlemen, eventually we're going to find everything. We're going to find everything. And I think that keeps him up at night more than anything. Because he's a fraud. And he knows he's a fraud. And he's not even worried about the fan base finding out or waking up from the pig noses or any of that shit. He's scared that the detractors are going to be proven right. And they're going to have all the paperwork, quote unquote, to prove it. That's what scares him more than anything.
An anonymous tipper says, don't forget PayPal takes a cut too. Yes, and PayPal takes various different cuts depending on the size of a tip contribution, depending on who's actually, like, in different countries get different amount of stuff taken out. Which I've seen, like, someone does it from another country, all of a sudden they have a bigger fee than someone else. And they just increase their fees.
I think Twitch is actually getting ready to implement something similar to that, too. Depending on where you're from and who you're trying to tip or send a cheer, or I think it's for a sub, actually. It's either a cheer or a sub, or it could even be both. Depending on what country the streamer's in and what country you're in, there could be a differential on how much you may have to pay. I remember Devin Nash talking about that probably about a month ago, maybe two, something like that, because he's not streaming right now. He's gone back to making videos, which I miss his streams on Twitch, but I'm glad he's going back to making videos though on YouTube. But Devin Nash talked about that too. So I think that's the thing that they're starting on Twitch as well.
The amount of fees that they're charging on contributions. So.
It's And that's a great screenshot. How is that insane, the amount of fees that they're starting to charge? That's everyday life. The electricity goes up, your internet goes up, gas goes up, the cost of food goes up. That right there is just part of, that's just part of life. A mature adult would understand that. But DSP wants everything to be stagnant and wants everything to be the same so he can be comfortable. Even the food he goes out and spends all his money on is probably gradually going up and he don't even notice. Oh well.
Oh, the relish that time. That's yummy. That's good. Okay. So we got some trolls. We're just going to take care of them right now. Get rid of them quickly. Here we go. It's a unique automatic grenade launcher. Sweet. Please bear with me while I get rid of these people. Scumbags. Okay. Krispy Kreme Knight tipped me $2. Said, sorry, I can't support you much, but these are stressful times you're going through. YouTube payments are slow. Don't get down in the dumps. Great to see more Fallout New Vegas. You know, it's not that YouTube payments are slow. It's that I get them once a month, and it's not as much as it used to be getting the payment both from Twitch and YouTube. It used to be Twitch would be sub revenue, cheering revenue, and some ad revenue, very little, but some ad revenue for running ads on the streams. YouTube would be all the ad revenue from the on-demand videos, and combined, it was way more than what I make just on YouTube now. So it's a huge loss, and that's what I mean. Like, I was in a great position, and Twitch literally fucked me. Twitch just said, oh, well, we don't care about you. We don't have to prove that you did anything wrong. We just don't want you in the partner program, and they kicked me out, and that's the end. Like, it completely threw me off track from being good this year. I was doing real well, and just like that, just fucked me over for no good reason. No warning, nothing.
They don't have to.
It would be nice.
Because here's another fucking semantic bullshit that he liked doing. He likes to fuck up, right, and do stupid shit, basically be Phil, and, you know, lash out at people, ridicule people, do all that nonsense. Then when he gets hit for it, this is how the conversation goes between him and Twitch. Oh, well, this person attacked me first. We don't care, Phil. You're a partner. We expect better of you. Well, he came on my stream, and he was doing all this and that, and I'm already really stressed out, and I didn't need that, and I was just trying to defend myself. We don't care, Phil. It's, you don't have to go about it that particular way. You fucked up, Phil. You're going to have to take this hit. Oh, well, I didn't know that, okay? Like, I didn't get a warning or anything. How long is the penalty going to be for? 3 days. Well, I need to stream. I stream for a living. I do this as my job. Like, if I lose 3 days worth of income, I'm going to be fucked, dude. Sorry, Phil. It's just the way it's got to be. You know, you got to do what you got to do. Dude, okay, this is my first time, this is my first offense doing this, right? Like, I've never done this up till now, because if I had, I wouldn't have done it again, because I would have known better. Can you just reduce it to 24 hours? And I won't let it happen again, okay? I'll have my moderators on top of it from now on. Can we just kind of give me a warning on this, and I'll take the 24-hour hit? Well, all right, Phil, maybe we can do that. That right there is the example of pretty much, I assume, what he said when he was indefinitely suspended from Twitch that one time because he shitted on that guy with blue hair or whatever it was. He was supposed to be indefinitely suspended. And then it turned into, somehow he got it brought down to like 3 days, I think. And then eventually it got knocked down to like 24 hours. It's a Gundam, and Almighty Tevin did a video about that. Well, I think a lot of people did, but you know what I mean. They definitely went over it. And that was insane when that happened. That was absolutely fucking insane when that happened. That should have never been a thing. He should have never been allowed. And that's what he needs. That's what he looks for. He wants to argue the smallest fucking point, which is ironic because he says that's what people do to him. And in a lot of cases, that's what the case is. He wants to argue the smallest fucking point and use whatever wiggle room he can to try to get away with something. and plead ignorance, pleading, oh, I didn't know better, or I didn't, or I was in a bad headspace, or this is my job, and if I don't have this, I don't have anything else. Just absolutely pathetic things that if you were someone listening to this, you would be like, Jesus Christ. And then once you were able to put a name to the face, you'd be like, oh, wow. And then you'd be more than willing, you might be a little bit more lenient about it. And that's what it really comes down to. His whole existence is basically pity. It's people feeling sorry for him. That's why he was so protected on Twitch as long as he was, until shit got shaken up. And whoever it was that was watching his ass ended up having to give that up, or they were ended up being ousted themselves. Because if you can get three people deplatformed off Twitch within a day or two of each other, that's influence. For whatever you want to call it, that's fucking influence. And Phil liked to argue his bullshit semantics and say, oh, I had nothing to do with that. That was other people who reported Tevin. That was other people who reported Tevin. That's why, you know, he went too far with other people, and that's why they ended up getting kicked up and off. Wouldn't even acknowledge the other two guys who got bumped off. He only wanted to focus on Tevin. But I had nothing to do with that. Other people did that. You're telling me Kekken had enough influence to go to Twitch and have him reported? Or to have Tevin deplatformed? Really? You're telling me Brian wouldn't even do that. So who else? Who else are your little minions had enough pull to make that happen? Because a managed partner is always going to have a little bit more pull than anybody else. Everybody else are essentially peons. But see, Phil don't think that way. Or he doesn't think other people will think that way. That's why he's been caught red-handed. And sooner than later, someone's going to come out and admit it. Sooner than later, someone's going to come out and admit, yes, we were in a flagging campaign against these people. Here's the screenshots for it. Sooner or later, that's going to come out. Because Phil definitely coordinated with people. Right? All we're waiting for is the screenshots to come out on it. And sooner than later, they will come out. I'm actually kind of surprised they haven't come out yet. Which means that whoever was involved in that is still involved with him at current. But sooner or later, that's just going to come out. When the Anonymous leaks were being dropped, that's the only thing I was actually looking for. I was looking for the flagging campaign against Almighty Tevin and those other two guys. That's all I really gave a shit about, or that's what I was hoping to see, I should say, out of those leaks. And it sucked that it didn't happen, but that's all I was looking for. I was looking for that. I was really, really looking for that. And someone has to have it. Someone has to have it. Unless Phil told them to delete it, to delete all the conversations, which is possible too. Because you can see in those Anonymous leagues, that dude sounds paranoid as shit. He sounds paranoid as shit. He wanted just to give you an example of that, if I remember correctly. DSP wanted the transcripts of conversations that his mods were having with other people, as well as themselves. He wanted transcripts of all that, and he wanted that stuff to be sent to him. Just so he could know what everybody was saying. AB conversations that he don't have no business, you know, have no real business in, right? He wanted transcripts of those things. That's kind of fucking crazy. That's kind of insane. But then again, it goes back to that Gaudi Gestapo thing I've been telling you guys about.
What? Absolutely would, but they're not going to do that. You know, YouTube's not going to do weekly payouts. No one does weekly payouts. It's not like a part-time job or whatever. You know what I'm saying? That's good. See, I don't know. There's been so many stupid conspiracies that I don't even know how to even discern between them anymore, right? When there's so many. And the thing is, if I bring one, like, for example, there's one going on where people claim that there's some application out there that I've never used or heard of. I guess it's called Line App. And they're like, oh, Well, we found that the cell phone number that we know is yours because it was doxed on the internet years ago, that cell phone number is somehow associated with Line app. Now, Line app is an app that I guess is used for people who talk behind the scenes when they play mobile games. So it's obvious that because there is a Line app with your cell phone number associated with it, that means you play mobile games and spend money on them. It's like, what? Like, how do you even associate that with that? And people keep bringing this up, like, just, like, 2 days ago.
What do you mean behind the scenes, by the way? It's an application that people use to chat with each other, like TeamSpeak or Discord or whatever the case may be. I guess it's really popular overseas. But what the fuck does he mean behind the scenes? And keep in mind, when he says behind the scenes, it's usually because he's sneaking around trying to do something. It's secretive, if you will. But this is how gills conversate with each other. At least some of them do, anyway. And he knows that. But whatever. I always thought that was an interesting thing to point out.
I'm like, dude, what the fuck are you talking about? I don't know anything about this app. I don't use Line app. I don't even know what it is. And these people just say this shit. And then they're like, okay, so how did I... When people brought this up like a year
that
ago...
That fake laugh first, gives him away too, by the way. It's one of his tells.
Heard this conspiracy theory. People were like, well, how could this be possible? I was like, you realize if what you're saying is true, okay.
And I don't know what the fuck is wrong with the hair on his chin, or at least directly below his lip, but just shave that off. That's disgusting looking. That's disgusting. Just shave off. I don't know why you would think you should show up on stream looking like that. And it puts emphasis on that drip, on that, not drip, on that droop, by the way, too. That gouty drip.
What you're saying is true. That this exists, this Line app, and that somehow there's an account with my phone number. Anyone could have done that, right? Because my phone number was public years and years ago. If you remember when I actually registered my website, the fucking website doxed all my information, including my phone numbers and shit.
No, it didn't. What happened was they had he's talking about GoDaddy, by the way. When he signed up for GoDaddy, they had a thing on there where if he paid, I can't remember. He said it was something small. It was like $5. It may have been $7. They would, it would be used to further isolate his information, basically. It would lock it down so it wouldn't be publicly available. He said no, he didn't care, it wasn't a big deal, whatever. Someone, I don't even remember the full lore behind it, you'd have to talk to someone like Tevin or Agent Proper or somebody like that, they would know. Someone ended up figuring out that they could, that through GoDaddy, they could figure out what his personal information was. And they went off that. And there you go. But the problem is, even before that, Phil used to have business cards that he used to send out with his name and address on it anyway. So eventually you were going to be able to find his phone number. So that, I don't consider that a dox. I don't consider that the website doxed him. He had theoretically a fail-safe for all that, and he was too lazy, too stupid, and too cheap to kick up $5 or $7 or whatever it was to fucking get it done. But yet he'll pay hundreds of dollars a year, if not more, to keep that piece of shit website of his up. Not even a website, a forum. But he'll pay, you know, hundreds of dollars a year to keep that fucking forum going. Makes no fucking sense.
So that's been public for how many years? So how is that evidence of anything? I don't even understand that at all. Like,
interesting how this idiot doesn't understand what two-step authentication is. It's really kind of wild how that was taking place. Because if you go by his narrative, right, somewhere down the line, he got a prompt from, he got some type of prompt or some type of notification saying, hey, your line account is about to be activated. Click this to approve it. And he clicked it. Because the account is active. That's proven. So somewhere, unless he went ahead and just clicked on it anyway because he's stupid, you could make the argument that, oh, well, maybe that was the case, GTG. Do you not remember when Superhound sent him that email with the link in it? and Phil clicked on that and, oh, Superhound got his IP? Who's to say that didn't happen to him? Who's to say that didn't happen? And that is a narrative that no one's brought up, and for good reason, but that is a narrative that one could make an argument for. You could do that. Phil is quite the fucking moron. He really is. He is very much an exceptional idiot. So that could have been a thing. And that's if you really want to dig deep into this shit to give him the benefit of the doubt. He is very stupid.
Has been doxxed years and years ago, right? How is it, like, I'll be honest with you, people have really gone
out of their way. If this idiot was so, wow, look at that spot there. See, this right, you can tell, this right here isn't fucking gray hair. This is just a blatant bald spot. You stupid fucking idiot. You fucking monkey. Anyway, it's even more funny to the fact that, well, Phil, if your phone number got doxxed, why didn't you just call the phone company and change your number? Which they will do. He could have done that for his home phone number, or he could do it for his cell phone, and he never did it. Why not? Who were you holding out for? Or were you really that lazy and that stupid to not go online after you get your phone number changed and log into some of your other accounts and just change your cell phone number with them too? Hop, skip, and jump. Oh well, just throwing it out there.
With me in regards to like stupid menial trolling shit, like sign up Phil's fucking emails for dumb spam and stuff like that, you know what I mean? So it's basically up to the point where like my information is so public, everyone, like for example,
he's literally talking himself in circles because he knows he can't get past that two-step authentication. He knows it. He's trying so hard to pig-splain this shit away, right, that he's starting to confuse himself because he has nothing to say. That's amazing. Absolutely amazing.
I can tell you right now, I guarantee you, someone went out there and registered me for every fucking website under the sun. They have my name, they have my address, they have a phone number that's associated with me, they have an email addresses, right? I have my public email addresses, you guys know them. I guarantee you people sign me up for everything, all right? So that's like saying, oh, there is a website that has an account that says Darkside Phil. It has an email that we know is yours associated with it. So that way, there's evidence you use that site. How? Anyone could go sign up for anything right now using my public information. But the thing is, they whip themselves into such a frenzy.
I don't know if that account was actually called Darkside Phil, Phil. I think that account was called They Call Me DSP. I think. It might have been called Darkside Phil, but I think it was actually called DSP. I know his original WWE account was called that before he changed the name on it, which is even more ironic too, because I can't remember if it was what was that guy's name? There's TJ Gamebox, and I think the guy's name is DT9494. No, it's BT9494, I think. My bad. I can't remember which one it was, but one of them said that theoretically you can't actually change your name on WWE Champions. So his account must be worth quite a bit if the company itself allowed DSP to break his own rules to keep playing the game. Like, they established that rule that you can't change your name, and yet he's done it like multiple times. So whoever it is at Scopey must really be looking at him as quite the cash cow. Certainly a fucking idiot, but quite the cash cow that they let him change his name that many times. At least as far as I remember. Because I thought that was not something you were able to do. And I know they were talking about it. I need to go back through that Kiwi Farms thread for the WWE Champions. Because there's a bunch of fucking juicy information in that shit. Absolutely fucking juicy information about the the game itself, how it works, and all that shit. It lays it all out.
With this information that they then act like it's evidence of anything. It's evidence of nothing. Anyone with a logical brain can say, what are you talking about? Like, Phil was doxxed a million years ago and all his information is out there. There's probably people on the internet who impersonate him all the time everywhere, right?
But he wasn't, but you weren't doxxed. He put out his own information. It was during one of his condo walkthroughs. He fucking had a letter on his counter wasn't bothering anybody. He chose to talk about it, flipped that bitch over, and showed Phil Brunell had his full name and address on that shit. And then flipped it back over and said, oh, you just docked yourself. Oh, I don't care if I docked myself. I'm a public figure. Who gives a shit? No one's got it, not going to do anything. He didn't dock. No one doxed him. He did it himself. He did it himself. That's like, and that right there continues. It's kind of like one of those subjects, like the whole swatting situation. I still don't think he was swatted. I think that was just a wellness call. I don't think he got swatted. I'm sorry. I still don't think he got swatted. I still think it was just a wellness call. But that's just me, though. But he didn't get doxxed. He doxxed himself.
Oh, how is that evidence of anything? But the thing that really gets me is apparently this Line app, and again, I don't know much about it. I've never used it. Apparently, the Line app is used for many different things. I guess it's a chat app. It's like you chat on it like a million other chat apps.
Okay? Well, that's ironic because he went ahead and led off into this conversation with, oh, it's an app that's used to talk to people behind the scenes. Now, all of a sudden, it's a chat app? You see how he's slowly but surely trying to change the narrative up? Because he still hasn't figured out a way to get himself across yet. Like, he's the victim. It's amazing how he goes through these fucking loopholes and shit. Pig-splaining. Fucking idiot.
There's evidence that if anyone had a chat app with my number or whatever, how is the evidence that it's used for a mobile game or that, you know what I mean? Like, even if that is the case, that someone used my information and registered, it's evidence of nothing. But you see what I'm saying? Like, they literally create this insane situation where it doesn't even make sense logically, but that's evidence of something. It's evidence. And that's what they do, is like, every conspiracy somehow, because there's 20 million conspiracies that they made up about me, somehow they all become a body of evidence that says I'm a bad person or something. It's like, but none of it is true. It's all your shit that you made up, or people doing things in my name or on the internet and shit. You see what I'm saying?
If that was the case, then debunk the bitch. And when I mean debunk it, I mean present evidence. Provide evidence to prove what you're saying or what these people are saying about you is not true. He can't do that. He has to use already existing, quote-unquote, not even evidence. He uses basically previously known information or prior information to fit into his narrative. He doxed himself. Yes, his information's out there. It's funny how this Line app is linked to WWE Champions. If you don't have the WWE Champions app, open up your phone and prove that you don't have it. Just go through your apps real quick and show that you don't have it. If you have no association with Line app, open up your phone real fast or show us your desktop. I think it's on his phone though. But show your desktop and show us that you don't have it. This idiot tried to tell us for the longest time he doesn't have a Discord, but he has the Discord app on his fucking desktop. So if you don't have Discord and you don't use it, why do you have the application on your fucking computer? Oh, I was given a Discord account when I became a managed partner on Twitch. Really? Because no one else did. So how do they give you an account? How do they actually give you an account? How do they assign you an account? How does Twitch do that? Now, I will say this, because this is a kind of an interesting thing. When Dr. Disrespect got deplatformed off of Twitch, whatever partnership deal or whatever it was that he had with Discord, that ended up getting dissolved too. Now, I'm not saying that he got kicked off of Discord, because I'm not saying that. He had some type of, he's not the only one. There's a bunch of the bigger influencers do too. He had some type of deal with Discord where, I don't know exactly how to explain the parameters of it, but how do I work? His Discord account had some type of perks. Like, you know what I'm saying? There's some type of advantages off it. I don't know if he could have actually monetized it any type of way, shape, form, or anything like that. But he does get perks for being who he is over maybe the standard user. Something along those lines. And after the whole situation with Twitch happened, Discord ended up dropping him from that program as well. Now, people were questioning, well, why would Discord do that? And no one really has ever come up with a reason for it. But the point being is, those two things happening in that small period of time does raise some red flags. But that doesn't mean that Twitch gave Dr. Disrespect a Discord account. That doesn't make any sense. It just doesn't. You were using Discord to talk to your fucking, your managed partner. Fair enough. But you still had to create the Discord account. Twitch didn't do it for you.
How that becomes evidence when it's nothing. I just never understood it. Overwatch trashed his super chat and says there's a code that verifies your number. What does that mean? There's a code that verifies your number.
What does that mean? Let's hear it again for prosperity's sake. Well, he drinks from a sippy bottle.
It's true. It's all your shit that you made up or people doing things in my name around the internet and shit. You see what I'm saying? And then it's like somehow that becomes evidence when it's nothing. I just never understood it. Overwatch trashed his super chat and says there's a code that verifies your number. What does that mean? There's a code that verifies your number. My number is public. That number was public since 2015. That number
he's still not explaining. Still can't explain it away. Still can't explain it away. We have an active account out there that someone's using that's linked to your phone number. Think about that. There's an active account that is linked to your phone number. They sent a code to verify that account. What does that mean? The fuck does that mean? I don't understand. So good. So good.
So how is that evidence? Like, what are you talking about? These people, see what I mean about these fucking people? And now this guy will probably talk about this all day. He'll just keep, it's what it's called. It's called moving the goalpost. So I'll say, no, what you're saying makes no sense.
He's almost given up. He's almost given up because he literally, this is the second time that he's tried to pig step or pig side or piggy sidestep, if you will, past this issue. And he has no answer for it. Because, let's be honest, this tard knows how fucking two-step authentication works. He understands that shit. And yet he has no fucking answer for this. He's been caught. He's essentially dead to rights. He's been caught dead to rights right here. I think, honestly, he's been caught dead to rights before this. Honestly, but whatever. He's caught dead to rights on this, and he can't even explain something easy away as two-step authentication. Phil, just because your number was put out there doesn't mean someone hacked your number. It doesn't mean someone cloned your phone number. That's what he's trying to see. That's the thing. He's trying to say someone has cloned his phone number without coming out and saying it. Because, one, he has no clue how that works. And, two, there is some technical things in there that he would have to try to explain away. And he can't. But that's really what he wants to go to. But he can't do it. And he definitely can't say, oh, well, my phone number was hacked. Because if that was the case, then why the fuck didn't you just get your number changed, Phil? And if that was the case, if your number got hacked, then fucking A, all your information would have been, like, all your utility shit. Anybody you owe money to who's linked to that phone number, anybody could essentially at least find out who those people are. You know what I'm saying? They could find out all those company names and everything. If they don't know it already. Jesus Christ, Phil. Trying so hard to piggy sidestep this shit.
That's not evidence of anything. So then they'll say something else ludicrous. I'll be like, okay, well, that's not evidence of anything. Then they'll say something else ludicrous. And then, you see what I mean? It's called moving the goalpost. They just keep
But it's not moving the goalpost. Just because you say that's not evidence of anything doesn't mean you're proving anything. And that's the thing that he really is trying to hold on to. Someone says something, oh, that's not evidence of anything. That doesn't prove anything. Okay, disprove it then. Well, why do I need to do that if that's not evidence of anything? You can't do that. And that's why the whole pro-Jared situation, the whole 7 years of slander of debunking the slander or whatever that bullshit is. I need to do a live stream on that, actually. That's why that nonsense makes no sense. I've already done a video on it, but you know what I mean. My opinions have slightly changed on some of that shit since then. But that's why that shit didn't work out the way he thought it would. It just came across him being stupid for the sake of being stupid. He didn't prove anything, or he didn't debunk anything, or he didn't disprove anything. All he came to the table with was his word, and that was it. And that wasn't even good enough. And this is coming from the same idiot that was so concerned on trying to debunk people off the back of Pro Jared, who ain't sat there and publicly fucked up by announcing his divorce to his wife on Twitter, that this retard forgot to fucking put his own wedding ring on after he took his one shower a week. Does anybody remember that? Because I remember when Tevin pointed that shit out on his stream, and then all of a sudden it got into Phil's chat, and then Phil got up and said that, oh, new, what is it? What is it? New husband making mistakes or some dumb shit like that. It's probably something he's been doing before, but he was so eager to do that live stream to try to debunk that list. That wasn't even his list, by the way. That was Dragon Killer's list. But he was so eager to debunk that list that this idiot didn't even remember to put his own fucking wedding ring on. Wow. Well, you see what pigs can do.
And further and further and further. Until I just get tired of answering. And I just don't want to talk about it anymore because I just don't want to fucking waste time on it. But then that, oh, see? So Phil couldn't answer every concern for 3 straight hours. So that means that it's all true. And that's how they win, because they have time for that shit. You know? I don't have time for that shit. I don't have time to answer every ludicrous accusation you have. You're just out of your fucking mind, man. Now people are saying, do you have to verify it? Verify what? The number. Verify what number? The phone number? What do you mean? They mean you have to verify the number with a code that sends a text to it. Okay? All right. Do you guys realize, and this is truthful, all, again, my emails, my phone numbers that I've had over the years, they're constantly hit with shit like that. Constantly. I mean it. Like, nonstop. Every day I get, did you sign up for this? Verify this. Here's a verification code. Here's a confirmation email. My fucking stupid home phone. All right? Which I've never used. I kid you not. I've never used my home phone number for anything. The only reason I have that home phone right there is because I do a bundle through Comcast that
I see. You're lying. I can debunk this shit right away, actually. You're lying on that. The reason why he has the home phone number is because the homeowners association needed a home phone line. Like, they needed a number to a home phone line. And that number used to be linked to a gate code for his gated community. So if he was getting something delivered or whatever the case may be, they would punch in a number. They would punch in a number associated with his phone, if you will, that would allow it to come in. Now, people were asking him even back then, why don't you have it associated to your cell phone? I don't remember what the excuse was, whatever. I think he said it had to be a home phone. And so that's why he had it. This whole nonsense here, I jumped the gun a little bit, but this whole nonsense here about him going into, oh, it's a bundle or whatever the case may be, that's not necessarily the case. Because if that was the case, he would have done that from the get-go. He'd have done that from the get-go. So that's it had to do with the alarm. It had to do with the homeowners association. And it might have even had to do with his alarm system, too. Now that I think about it. The home phone might have been linked to the alarm system, which is why the homeowners association required a home phone. Now that I think about it. It's something along those lines. It's something along those lines. I know I've heard that before, too. And that's all. And he's only talked about that within the last couple of years.
If I keep the phone, if I got rid of that phone, the overall cost of my internet and phone would actually go up if I got rid of that phone. Okay, so I've never used that phone before for anything. That phone rings constantly. Constantly. It's solicitor shit. It's other. I've never used it. I've never even put that phone number on the internet, but it rings constantly because people got it and they sign it up for everything. Do you see what I'm saying? So I constantly.
That's not true either. I can almost, and this is something that all of you should know, honestly. If that phone rings constantly, there's a phone in his office, ladies and gentlemen. So why don't you hear constant phone calls up in the office? Are you going to sit here and tell me, oh, Phil is smart enough to turn the sound off of his phone while he's streaming, but then when he's done streaming, he turns the house phone's volume back up? X the doubt on that. Does Phil have two phone lines? He has a business home phone line. He has a business line, and then he has a home phone line. It's possible. We just know he has two internet lines. Don't know if he has a business home phone. He certainly doesn't need that. And three, he's overpaying for all that bullshit anyway.
Bothered by that shit. Everything. Every phone line I've ever had, every email address I've ever had, constantly gets hit up for this. So how is that evidence of anything? They sent a verification request to the phone number. And? I get those constantly, all the time. So what does that mean? Nothing. They need to get the code to confirm. How do they get it if you physically have the phone on you? What do you mean? You have to put in a code. Put in a code where? What are you talking about? Oh, you can't have a LINE account if you don't have a code. I don't know. There's no code that's ever been entered into a LINE account because I don't have a LINE account. And so but that's what I'm saying. Like, there's also forum.
Yet again, that little, that's the tell. You would think he'd be smart enough to not have to do that as much, but he can't because it's something he does subconsciously.
You have to put in a code. Put in a code where? What are you talking about? Oh, you can't have a LINE account if you don't have a code. I don't know. There's no code that's ever been entered into a LINE account because I don't have a LINE account. And so but that's what I'm saying. Like, there's also forum posts and things out there in my name. And people are like, well, that's evidence that you have it because it's in your email and that forum is there. It's like, but I didn't do it. I didn't verify it. I ignore it. All that shit's on, like, blacklist. I get spam emails all the time of that kind of stuff. I just ignore it. So how did it work? I don't know. Maybe. Now, I don't know specifically if I'm talking about LINE or whatever. But maybe these things allow you to create an account. All right? And as long as you have general information, the account sits there. And it's a dormant account. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sure right now there's a million dummy accounts that are called Darkside Phil on the internet that aren't me. But they created them using my information, and they just sit there dormant, never used, but it still says that I'm a member. Like, what was it? Like, years ago, someone was like, Phil, we have evidence that you're on a gay porn site. And I'm like, well, I have news for you. I'm not on a gay porn
Continue site. Continue to talk ourselves in circles. We're talking about an account that's actively been used. He has to go ahead and try to spin that and say, oh, no, it's a dormant account. It's a dormant account, and it just has my name on it, and because it has my name on it, people think that I'm using it. Slowly but surely, can't explain shit away. Can't explain a goddamn thing away. This is insane. And here's the thing. Why didn't he just drop it? If he doesn't want to spend his time worrying about this bullshit, why didn't he just drop this conversation? He's literally digging himself a bigger hole. Or, as we like to say over here, we just keep feeding him rope, and he's setting himself up for the fucking noose, for the gallow, if you will. Give him enough rope and he'll hang himself is the point. And that's exactly what he's doing. The engineer of his own fucking self-destruction. God damn, dude. Just give it up. If you're not going to admit it, then shut the fuck up. Seriously. If you're not going to admit to it, then just shut the fuck up.
I have nothing to do with that. I don't go to porn sites in general anyway, but I'm not part of a gay porn. But here's an account with your email associated with it. I'm like, and? You see what I'm saying? What does that have to do with anything? So I don't know what you guys are talking about. I don't care. Like, you have to understand.
Oh,
I
and mean, just for the record, by the way, that it's a coping mechanism. Yet again. It's another one of these ticks that he has. It's a fucking coping mechanism. And it's stupid. And it's stupid. And he's done it for so many fucking years that he just can't stop it, basically. God damn.
There's like 10, 20 people on this stream that are all talking about this right now. What you're, the stuff that you deal in is so disassociated from reality for most people. Like, we don't care about your bullshit. You understand that, right? Like, I'm sorry that I'm not trying to be insulting. But you have to understand that what you're saying and doing is so disassociated from normal life. We don't sit there on the internet hashing out conspiracy theories and debunking them. We don't. We have lives. Normal people have like lives where we do stuff with our time. We don't sit there on the internet with people like you debunking conspiracies and hashing up conspiracies. Like,
you're a liar, though. That's why you have debunk. That's why you did a debunking stream. That's why you have pre-streams where you're trying to debunk shit. Idiot, you don't have a life. Your whole life is lived on the internet. That's the reality. You think that you can go ahead and push the narrative of mental illness on people to try to go ahead and shield yourself and other people who are agreeing with you, right? But in actuality, you live your whole fucking life on the internet. You don't have anything else. You don't have not a goddamn thing. And the fact that you can even try to say it with your fucking drooping face makes no sense. When he is not streaming, right? When he's not streaming, he's focused on YouTube getting his content, his trash, over there. When he's not doing that, he's on fucking Twitter. When he's not doing that, he's on Kiwi Farms. And that's it. That is essentially his day. Even if he says, I'm watching TV, I'm watching a movie with my wife, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. He's also reading Kiwi Farms. He's also reading Twitter. He's also playing WWE Champions or whatever other mobile game. His whole life consists of being online. He has nothing else. He doesn't have a goddamn thing else to do. And proof of that goes back to his wedding night. The night that he should have been in there consummating his marriage. He was sitting there on Instagram deleting people's messages almost all night. That's what he was doing. Instead of spending his wedding night doing what he was supposed to do with his soulmate, with the woman that he loves, he's sitting there arguing people and deleting posts on Instagram. This man don't have a life. Furthest from it. If that was the case, he wouldn't talk. He would be able to talk about more than just internet shit. But he can't because he has nothing else. Doesn't have a goddamn thing else to talk about.
Going on in my life that's important and meaningful to me, my family, my cat right here, Jasper Kitty. Give him a nice pet. I don't have time to worry about your bullshit. I don't. I really don't have time to worry about your bullshit that you make up about me every day. I'm not going to sit here and try to find a way to disprove every ridiculous thing that says about me because I have better things to do. I have a stream to put on right now. Right now I'm trying to figure out where the vault is, guys, what I'm trying to do. Right, there you go. General of Thunderous Fire says, that's the equivalent of like saying turn off the internet and it stops internet bullying. It does, you're right. The equivalent is like either I address it, and if I address it, it's never good enough. It's never good enough. There's always another thing. Like I said, I'll answer logically, okay, here's the truth. Oh, well,
how did we go from, I want you to think about this. How did we go from, I have a life, we have a life, and we don't have time to address all this internet shit, to being, oh, if you're tired of getting bullied, turn off the internet. You're right. That's why I try to address it. But I thought you said you couldn't address all these things, and you wouldn't, because you have a life. And then we circle right back around to, oh, well, I have to address all this. What? How do you contradict yourself that quickly like that? And he doesn't even remember his previous narrative now. Damn. That's wild.
I honestly don't know. So maybe it's this. Maybe it's this. And then it's not good enough because they keep going with further conspiracy. So there's no point in me answering anything. But if Phil ignores it, well, that means that it's true. You see? So it's a lose-lose situation. When you have this many nut jobs constantly just fucking making shit up about you, you can't win. Like, you'll never win because they will always say it's not good enough. Or, like I said, then if I address it logically and calmly and I answer honestly, they move the goalposts to the next thing.
How is it being logical by saying, I don't know what that means? What is that? I don't know what that means. I don't understand how that works. What does that mean? How is that logical? How is that even calm? His delivery was getting very erratic at that point. Huh? Okay.
Well, how, for how many... all right, the best example of this, the absolute best example of this, is that whole insane discussion about the whole escort thing, right? My mouth is burning. Where supposedly there was an escort that I had hired to fly across the globe to spend time with me. I didn't really have a girlfriend. I was lying about that. It was all bullshit, right? How many months did that go on? 3-4 constant months where every stream, people came in and trolled me about it and everything. And it was completely all 100% fabricated. But again, every time that I answered...
Before even that, right? This isn't me pushing the goalpost back, ladies and gentlemen. This is me setting the stage. Let me actually frame the picture for you. This idiot, for months, was telling people that he was alone. He was miserable. He was vulnerable. And he was trying to figure out how he was going to make his way in the world after Leanna left his dumbass. He lied to these people for months about being alone. You know what I'm saying? Having his little pity parties and shit on stream and shit. Shitting on other people because they lost somebody. But their loss couldn't be greater than the King of Suffering's loss. Shit like that, right? Then come to find out, as you would find with your typical thought, he does have somebody. And he's had somebody for a while. So all those prior months, right, that he was saying that he was alone and he was really stressed out and all this bullshit, he was actually talking to someone during that period of time, and he had lied to these people for months on end. Let's keep that in mind. Now I'll let him finish talking and then I'll come in.
Logically, they moved the goalpost to the next thing, right? And the whole thing was fake, but, you know, it's few and far between when I can get a situation like that where I can outright eventually prove that something's fake because someone was caught out and it was admitted that it was fake. It's rare that happens because the rabbit holes that these people make go so deep that there's no way you could ever dig yourself out of them once you're down them because they just keep building on top of it. It's like going into the Matrix and you can't escape.
Okay, let me cut it there because now he's starting to annoy me. So outside of him lying, let's start, like I said, starting the whole situation off. We started off with him lying for months, saying he was alone when he was really talking to someone. The escort situation and whatnot, the only thing that was wrong about the escort situation is that Kimberly Brinks, who was out there pushing the narrative, a narrative that not everybody even believed, right? Was this high-paying or this high-class European escort, and Phil was paying her ridiculous amounts of money to spend time with him. That right there, that whole scenario with the escort forced his hand and him kind of having to fully admit that he had a girlfriend and you guys were going to see her soon and all this bullshit. That kind of pressed his hand a little bit. But secondly, the Kimberly Brinks was Catherine. That's really what it is. She's not an escort. He's not paying money for her to spend time with him. Actually, let's scratch out the latter, because actually he was. She's not an escort. She's some chick who lived in Michigan who was living with her boyfriend at the time, and Phil was flying her back and forth to come visit him. That's what the scenario is. The only difference was she wasn't an escort. That was it. And he wasn't paying thousands upon hundreds of thousands of dollars to come out and visit him, which is why a lot of people didn't think that scenario was real anyway. But there was clearly something going the fuck on. And then the catfishing thing came out with Brenda and her husband, who were behind the Kimberly Brinks persona in the first place, which turned out to be this big ass catfishing empire that nobody knew anything about. And so by pushing the narrative on the escort saga, right, and by people continuing to talk about that, it brought so much attention to the Kimberly Brinks persona that ended up exposing the situation with the catfishing shit. And for all we know, they were extorting money from Phil. I am of the belief that they got a couple of thousand dollars out of Phil. I honestly think they did. Now, can I prove that? No. Do I think that, though? Yes. I am very much of the swine craft theory that that's what that situation is. That I am of the Gowdy theory that they did get some money out of him. Certainly. And it's a good thing that so much attention with this Kimberly Brinks thing came out on that, because that's what exposed that whole catfishing empire, which ended up getting that weight off Phil's back. So he should be grateful. He should be grateful in a similar manner to the whole Laveria Media Fotabi situation. He should be very grateful that the Kiwi Farms kept pushing the narrative on that, or at least kept digging into it to see what was going to come out of that. Because there were people almost from day one that were kind of questioning that situation. It was entertaining, though. It was entertaining as fuck. It was entertaining as hell when that shit was going on. But there were still people that questioned it. And it, yet again, if they had dropped the narrative, who knows what they could have done to Phil behind the scenes with that bullshit? Who could say? But that's me branching off a little further than I need to. The point being is, Phil was paying a woman to come out and see him. That was Catherine. She lived in another state. He was paying all the expenses for that. She had a boyfriend who she was living with while she was speaking to Phil. And when I say speaking to Phil, they weren't even talking on the phone. They spent their entire relationship up until the time they met, essentially talking either in DMs on Twitter or texting each other. And Phil admitted that. Phil admitted that when people were pressing him on, why don't he reach out and talk to John? And he said, John has my number. My number hasn't changed. I haven't done anything with my number. He has my number. He can reach out and call me. Which, that shit ended up fucking him over, because people had already linked the WWE account that he had to his home phone number. When people got him on that whole situation with John and how he had the same number, it only confirmed this shit that you're listening to right now. That's how he got himself in this whole mess in the first place. Or this particular rant, I should say. That's how he got caught. Or that's how he unexpectedly, or unbeknownst to him, he ended up confirming the nonsense. So that's what it comes down to. So this whole thing about, oh, the escort saga was a loss, that's bullshit. That's fucking bullshit. And that's not moving the goalpost. He was paying a woman to come out and see him. That was Catherine. The only difference was, or the only mistake to be made, is she wasn't an escort. And there was somebody out there who was posing as Kimberly Brinks, who was posing as an escort to push that narrative. And yet again, a lot of people didn't even believe it. A lot of people thought it was funny. And just about almost everybody reported on the shit, or at least talked about it. So this whole thing about him being able to use that as his one win over Kiwi Farms is bullshit. I've always thought that was bullshit. Because like I said, that whole relationship's fraudulent anyway. But that's just my two cents on it.
Building virtual walls in front of you, you can't possibly pass. Have any of their lies hurt me off stream? Yes. But I'm not going to go into detail about that, because that's the thing. Like, the reason people do it is twofold. Obviously, they want to slander me online, but a lot of these people do it because they feel like, oh, if everything I've done somehow had a concrete outcome, then, you know, I've done it. I made it, right? So I just basically am like, I'm of the impression that there's no reason to address any of this concretely and tell you every detail, because if I do, it'll just promote further mistreatment and further trolling. You see what I'm saying? So that's why I don't talk about a lot of that stuff. And the funny part is, people are like, what you do? Actually, I don't. Actually, the little bit that I tell you guys on streams is like 1/10 of the amount of shit that has happened to myself and Kat over the last several years. But I only tell you very little.
No. Here's the reality. All the theories that are out there on them, he doesn't want to. If he comes out and tells you some of the shit that happened, it confirms what detractors, trolls, haters, and critics have already said. And he knows it. Especially about Catherine. Because her whole history is kind of out there for us. Like all the I don't even want to get into all that. A lot of that shit's dark as fuck. But a lot of the bullshit that happened to her and her sister throughout their childhood and all that nonsense and all that, he would have to end up confirming it. You know what I mean? And he don't want that shit to come out. And he don't want to. He also don't want to come out the situation with Subaru Man. He don't want to have to come out to and admit that bullshit. Or he doesn't want to confirm that we were right on that. He doesn't want to do that either. He knows he's dead to rights on all that bullshit. He knows all that. But he don't want to come out and confirm it. Because it does make him look bad. It does kind of make you look like a scumbag that you were messing around with a chick who was living with her boyfriend at the time. Seems kind of shitty. Especially when you supposedly were alone and you were just coping with your breakup. That don't look good either. That really looks bad. And he don't want to have to face that either. You know, because that's what a coward does.
People don't... let's just go the extra mile and troll Phil for it, you know? You just don't want to waste time on that, you know? Alright, so Aaron Carpenter tipped me $50 and I hope all is well, and I hope this helps. That does absolutely help, Aaron. We're now up to $255 and climbing, and I appreciate that support, man. Thank you very much, Aaron. You're tied for the top tip with Chris right now, so thank you for that. And of course, a bunch of super chats came in, and they're all about this bullshit. So I'm just going to ignore them. I'm going to read them, but I'm going to ignore them. So for example, here we go. To create an account in the LINE app, you must verify your number, or you cannot proceed in his account with the number was found. He is lying. So what do you want me to say? I don't know anything about this app.
Okay, dumbass. I'm just gonna ignore it. I'm gonna read them though, but then I'm gonna ignore them. Proceeds to read it and then start to answer, and then starts to actually answer to it. Oh, the amount of patience this shit requires is fucking amazing sometimes.
Found a way to make an app account supposedly in my name. Actually, I don't even know if you even said that. Is it even in my name or is it using my number? I don't even know, nor do I care anymore. I just don't care. Because that's what I mean. People I got him now. No, I don't know. I don't have any answer to your crazy conspiracy.
Well, how's that an intelligent answer then? And you kind of, you inadvertently exposed yourself to. So good. Like I said, let him sit around and keep talking. He'll fuck himself up. You don't have to necessarily push the narrative on him. Just keep putting, you could literally put pressure on him and he'll crack. It's just what he is. It's what it is. When he has to answer for something and he has to really flush the situation out, it's when he'll fuck himself up. You just got to keep the pressure on him. You got to keep the pressure on him. He falls into that category of people who don't work well under pressure. It's just what he is. Just keep putting pressure on his dumb ass.
I don't. And again, by the way, none of this means anything. Because... When last year when people started saying this to me, the LINE app apparently is just simply an application used generically for communication over the internet. It's not evidence of anything. Apparently the LINE app could be used.
Wait, I thought initially we were using it was used to talk to people behind the scenes. Then it was to talk to people in a chat. Now it's just an application that's out there to speak to people online. You saw how we enchanted the narrative three different times? All in the same video. Let's keep going.
If someone just wanted to have a chat with someone across the world, you get the LINE app, you can chat with them if you have each other's account. I guess it's kind of like Discord. That would be the equivalent of saying, oh, we just know that Phil has a Discord, therefore we know that he uses it to play mobile games and stuff. It's like, no, you don't. You don't have that evidence at all. Like, that doesn't make any sense what you're saying, but that's what I mean. These people are nuts. These people are absolutely nuts. There's no, if there was evidence, they would present it. They have no evidence of anything. They just make these conspiracy theories up.
And here's the fucked up part about that, too. He's like, they have no evidence of anything, so they can't prove anything, right? Even though he knows that there's a WWE Champions there's a WWE Champions thread, or sub-thread, if you will, in his thread on Kiwi Farms. But he doesn't want to tell people that, because if they go and read it, they're going to put two and two together. So he keeps saying they have no evidence, they have no proof, and then yet he's very, very quick to tell you these assholes on Discord say all this, or not on Discord, on Kiwi Farms have all these conspiracy theories about me, and it's all bullshit, they're all liars, they're all mentally ill. So don't go over there and read any of that stuff because they're all stupid, they're all liars, and they're all mentally ill. But it's okay for him to go over there and read that shit, but he can't debunk anything because he knows everything over there is essentially the truth, and they got him dead to rights. But he can prevent everybody else from going over there or he tries to at least, prevent everybody else from going over there and finding out what's really going on. Womp womp.
Again, there was like two or three super chats. I'm not even exaggerating. Two or three super chats all saying the same fucking thing. So I'm just going to ignore it. I'm just going to ignore them. Okay. Romy Rose says, if I could take weekends off if money wasn't an issue. If money wasn't an issue, I would definitely have 2 days off a week. One day would be to go out and do all the things that need to be done. Like, for example, any important appointments, grocery shopping, running errands, all that stuff. I would definitely do all that in one day and with my wife. And then I would like another day where once a week, my wife and I can either just stay home and relax together. We would do stuff around the house, home improvement, cleaning, etc. Or if we ever wanted to do something different, for example, we've wanted to go to the zoo for 2 years. 2 fucking years. We've wanted to go to the zoo. We haven't.
Okay, first off, yet again, this goes back to what I said about his habit of going out on Tuesdays with his mother, and he tried to do the same thing with Panda. He's trying to do the same thing with Catherine. Well, he is doing the same thing with Catherine. So that's him just continuing that bullshit narrative. Then, I would like to have another day off so we can spend time together, do home improvements, which is weird because you don't know how to use a hammer nor anything else. So why would he do that? And to clean the house, which seems even weirder because I thought Catherine does that on her days off. So why would she need you there? You don't clean anything. So semantics on that. Also, if he did take another day off where he could just sit around the house or whatever the case may be, people would be like, well, why can't you just edit your videos? Oh, because I want to spend time with my wife. But didn't you run errands with her and spend time with her on your other day off? So you're telling me you don't have 3 hours out of a 24-hour day to edit some videos? Just for example, that'd be really light editing, but you know what I mean. Whatever. It is what it is on that. it is what it is on that. Or if they don't do home improvements or anything, they could actually go out and do something fun, like go to the zoo. How much of a broke bitch must you be that you can't afford to go to the zoo? For 2 fucking years, him and this chick couldn't go to the zoo. Because y'all broke? Or what? Exactly. Or what exactly? He took her to the Space Needle, and I don't remember him taking an extra day off for that, at least not that I remember. So, what's preventing you from doing anything? I don't know. Just thought I'd throw it out there.
Either I was too busy with work, or we didn't have the money, or she couldn't get the time off of her work, and then
so COVID happened. You a broke bitch, basically. Because Catherine has like 3 or 4 days off. At least 3. She has at least 3 days off a week. And your work is a joke, so I'm not even gonna give any of that credence. So she has 3 days off at the very least. You guys couldn't, even if she had 2 days off, there's still an opportunity to go. Or you guys are broke. She couldn't pay for you guys to go to the zoo this time, and you guys couldn't pay, and then you could pay the following time or some shit. Or you guys go half and half or whatever. Tell you, that woman must not pay for shit in that house. She must not pay for shit in that house. Well, so much for that whole second income narrative he was pushing back in 2017.
Happened and everything got fucking closed. It has been ridiculous. We want to go to the zoo. But how can we go to the zoo when the zoo is about an hour away? So that's 2 hours of driving. All right. How can we do that when we actually have to do all our other shit? Like we have to do our grocery shopping, errands, and everything. Like, we just haven't had a way to do it. We would have to take an extra day off. If I take an extra day off, that's a day I don't make any money, and now I can't pay for stuff. So it's been incredibly stressful and frustrating.
Well, first off, who gets frustrated because they can't go to the zoo? That sounds kind of retarded. Secondly, it sounds like he just doesn't want to make a 2-hour drive. That's kind of what that sounds like. That's really what it sounds like. It sounds like he just don't want to make a 2-hour drive. And three, every day that I'm not here, I'm missing out on money. You know what I'm saying? And I can't pay for anything. He works 6 days a week and he says he can't pay for anything. So what's the difference? If you really think about it. This idiot works 6 days a week, if you want to call it work, and he says he's barely paying for anything. But he's frustrated because they can't go to the zoo. With all of that Vestreak money, we still haven't figured out a way to pay for a new air conditioner, go to the zoo, get a new computer, get a new laptop, get a new green screen, and settle all of our taxes. We still couldn't figure out a way to do any of that. Okay, sure. No problem.
To get to the point where we have that more flexibility. Like, for example, we were there. How do you think my wife feels? When earlier this year I outright told her, you know, hon, we're doing good. You know, everything's going good on Twitch. And as long as things keep going the way they're going, later this year, likely I'll be able to start saving up money again, which I haven't been able to do in years. And we'll be able to actually maybe do something. Like maybe go to Seattle for a weekend, or maybe go to the zoo, or do the things we wanted to do. And then what happened? I lose my Twitch partnership, right? How do you think she fucking felt, right?
It sounded like she made a fucking mistake. That's what it sounded like. It sounds like, I guess that's what happens when you live with regret. Hold on, let me start this back up again.
That more flexibility. Like, for example, we were there. How do you think my wife feels? When earlier this year I outright told her, you know, hon, we're doing good. You know, everything's going good on Twitch. And as long as things keep going the way they're going, later this year, likely I'll be able to start saving up money again, which I haven't been able to do in years. And we'll be able to actually maybe do something. Like maybe go to Seattle for a weekend, or maybe go to the zoo, or do the things we wanted to do. And then what happened? I lose my Twitch partnership, right? How do you think she fucking felt, right? And you know, me, I've been
through the ringer over the... yet again. bad decisions, rip. I kind of understand why Tyrone and Jim have a place in her life. Kind of makes sense. And maybe, just maybe, sticking around with Subaru Man wouldn't have been a bad idea. That's probably what that was. That's probably how she was feeling. You know what? I didn't have it so bad with Subaru Guy or Subaru Man. Maybe I should have just went ahead and just dealt with that shit. You know what I'm saying? That dude seemed to really care about her. He wanted to see her do better for herself, and she wanted to kind of lay around and be a neep, or a neat, or whatever they call that shit. And, yeah, basically. I'm pretty confident that she's like, you know what? I might have fucked up. Mistakes were probably made. Yeah, that's probably what she's thinking. Certainly. That's probably what she thought. Holy shit. Damn, Phil. And see, here's the thing, too. If you're going to disappoint yourself, that's one thing. But you lack the fucking... You lack the self-awareness and the situational awareness that it ends up trickling over on other people. It ends up becoming other people's problems. Like, you don't see that? And I'm not even talking about just his audience or his viewer base or, you know, the pay pigs or whatever the case may be. I'm talking about his failure is so infective or infectious that it affects the people that are directly around him. And he has to use that shit as a shield. I really don't know what's worse. I know the meme still floats around that Meek Mill's L's are fucking a sexually transmitted disease, but I mean, I think DSP is worse. I think DSP is worse. And what was it all for? Let's be honest, you don't give a shit about that woman, dude. She's just there to make your life more comfortable. But then you're up here crying poor. Wow.
Years, I've had horrible things happen to me nonstop. So I kind of know, I'm used to it. I almost feel it sometimes that I'm like punch drunk about it and shit. She's not. You know what I mean? Like, she's like, I can't believe it. And I'm like, yeah, I can't believe it either. Oh, look. I got to read this. I definitely got to read this. But do you see my point? Like, and it just sucks. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of like working my butt off.
And right yet again, and I can understand why the theory persists if she even has a job, because allegedly, when Phil lost his job, when he lost Twitch, he went downstairs to tell Catherine, and Catherine broke out crying. Now, that seems strange if you have someone who's working and she's like, okay, well, you know, this is a setback, but we'll work it out. She immediately breaks down crying? Sounds like someone who thought her cash cow, or, let's be more accurate about the situation, her piggy bank just broke. That's kind of really what it sounds like. That's kind of seems what the issue is. Because remember, it's Phil. He's uncancelable. Uncancelable, if you will. You know what I'm saying? He can always bounce back and recover. Why would she cry over that? Why would she shed any tears over that dumb shit? I mean, Phil was the one who said for years, she loves him, she loves their home, and she was the one who changed jobs and tried to pick up extra hours and was giving up over 3/4 of her paycheck just to keep things going. Which, yet again, sounds like more symptoms of a bad decision. Something to think about. just something to think about.
Now, streaming 6 days a week, you could argue and say, well, that's not really work. It's not as tough as other people who work 6 days a week. And fair enough. You're free to say whatever you want about it. But 6 days a week, I'm here full-time in this office with you guys, right? I don't get to spend that time with my wife. I get one day a week, and that most of that day is used running around doing errands and shit, you know? It sucks. I want to have a more meaningful life with my wife, and I can't right now. And every time that it looks like I get a chance where things are getting better, something screws me. Taxes you didn't pay correct for years and years. You know, finally the crap hit the fan, I had to declare bankruptcy. And then it looks like I'm recovering from that. Oh, Twitch kicks you out of the partner program, doesn't care about you. Dacky Smur says, if I was hitting the tips goal consistently, would I be able to take 2 days off a week? It definitely, let me put it this way, it would definitely put me in a position where I don't have
to do a stream like... The answer is no. And you could tell the answer is no. Because at the end of the day, Phil constantly needs a new narrative that brings people in to keep giving him money. If he was able to hit his little $150 a day or whatever, or not a day, as little $150 a stream, so $300 a day, it wouldn't be enough. If he raised it back up to the $200 a stream, which would be $400 a day, it wouldn't be enough. And if he was able to somehow double that and make it $800 a day, he would still try to find a reason or try to find a way to prod people to give him $1,000 a day. And if they were able to keep that up for a number of months, well, why can't you guys give me $1,500 a day? That's just how his mind works. It'll never be enough money. It'll never be enough money. All it is more disposable money. That's all it is. He will never sit there and try to improve his way of life, per se. He'll never try to improve his streams or his business, if you will, or whatever you want to call it. He'll never do any of that. He'll just find new ways of spending it on shit. On his off time, so the king can feel like a real king. That's all he would spend it on. And that's why someone, air quotes, had to get him that new Nintendo Switch after the first one bricked. That's why someone, in air quotes, had to get him the new laptop. That's why someone, in air quotes, had to get him the new chair. That's why someone, in air quotes, had to give him the Xbox, the chair, the laptop. Someone's going to have to give him the new desktop eventually. It always has to be on somebody else's dime. It'll never be something that he chooses on his own. Why spend his own money when he's gotten this far conning other people into doing it for him? Why would he need to? In the same way that, as many detractors have said, why would he feel the need to get a real job? He's convinced people, he's conned other people into letting him do this his way for all these years. He can't go back to being regulated and shit. He just can't do it. He can barely do it now. Look at how autistic his schedule is. He could change his schedule if he wants to. He can't. Because he's constantly trying to prove that this is a real job. It's a real 9-to-5. It's a real career and it deserves to be respected. But the way you do it is not something to respect. You beg. Where's the actual work at? Oh, the work's here me sitting here every day playing games and recording it for the internet. That's not work. That's not work. I'm sorry. That's not work. So where's the work at? Me pressing these buttons, that's not work. Where's the work at? And then that's when the conversation ends and he says that you're a dumbass. Instead of him saying, oh, me being entertaining. Well, you're not entertaining. That's not me pushing the goalpost back. You're not entertaining. And that's why he can't get into a conversation with a group of detractors or even a detractor. He can't do it. Even the most reasonable, like if I had to choose somebody off the top of my head, I'd say probably LSB, to be honest. When it comes to being reasonable, he kind of is the first person that comes to mind at the moment. Even Agent Proper, because Agent Proper would trap him sooner than later. I mean, I think LSB would trap him eventually sooner than later too, but Agent Proper would trap him sooner than later. Or Piece of Peace, or playing with your beliefs. I can actually think of a handful of people now that I think about it. Especially from like the newer generation of detractors that he could talk to that I think are reasonable. But they would all entrap him eventually. And I think DSP knows that. But they would all entrap him eventually. The point being, though, is that he can't sit down and he can't talk logic to those people. To any of those people. You know what I'm saying? He just can't. He's too scared of them. And he knows that all these people are smarter than he is. You know what I'm saying? It was different with Quartering because Quartering chose to be a bitch and be submissive and lay on his back. You know what I'm saying? And take whatever comes about. Rich isn't going to do that because Rich knows too much about him. And Rich wants the hard-hitting questions. Because, in honesty, and I'll try to be brief about this, but I'm not brief. What Rich wants is he wants to get him on the show. And in truth, Rich only needs him there for like 20 minutes. All he needs to do is hit Phil hard enough with the right type of questions and get Phil stuttering, get him stammering, and get him to walk off. And that's it. And in Rich's mind, he's got him. He's got his gotcha moment. And he's solidified. That's all Rich needs. I know Rich tries to tell you guys that he wants to get him into a conversation. He wants to hear his side of the story and all that bullshit. Rich knows there's no point. There's no point in that. Because Phil's going to try to dictate the narrative from the beginning. His best bet is to try to get Phil so flustered that he'll walk off, or he can try to turn it into an argument or a shouting match or whatever the case may be. That's what Rich wants. That's what Rich needs, to be honest with you. Because that's money. That's money. Because look at the Quartering interview. You see what you get if you try to be reasonable. You know what I'm saying? Or not even reasonable, if you try to be submissive. That's what you get. And that's just boring. You have to get him in a confrontation, so to speak. You got to get him riled up. That's where the money's at. And Phil knows that. And Phil don't want it. That's why he doesn't want to agree to that interview. Because Rich is also not going to agree to some fucking pre-recorded bullshit. That shit needs to be live. That shit needs to be live in full fucking effect. Because that's where the money's at. That's where the attention's at. And that's how he knows he's going to get Phil sweating. And Phil don't want to put himself in that position. Well, that's funny. If you're not a liar, if you're not a con artist, then what do you have to hide? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what are you scared of? What do you have to hide from? And that's why he doesn't want to go on Rich's podcast. That's exactly why he don't want to go on there.
Today, a marathon stream. And it would definitely put me in a position where, yeah, if I could hit the tips goal every single stream I did, I could save up a bit and we could consider stuff like that. But, you know... But I don't want to talk about this all fucking day. I don't. I'm here to chill with you guys and have a good time and hopefully raise some funds to help out. I'm not here to dwell on the negativity, right? I'm not. I'm going to keep moving forward positively and believing that at one point the bad stuff's going to stop happening to me and I'm going to get to the point where I can actually improve things around me, you know? And we'll see. I hope for the best. So here's someone claiming someone knows my income. That is false. There's no way you could possibly know my income. So enjoy your delicious permanent ban from my chat. And have a nice day. Have a nice fucking day. Just more conspiracy theory bullshit.
I feel like it's times like that he forgets that his bankruptcy documents are out there. And that they're public record. But whatever.
Mel. Here we go again.
As well as you've had some really smart people who have been able to track his memberships, his tips, his super chats, and stuff like that. I feel like it's amazing how he's oblivious to all of those things.
Him says bonus gem damage is not a conspiracy theory. It's not. Really. I want you to think about this. Do you know, you guys probably have no idea what this even means, do you? Because if you're not part of the conspiracy group, you'd have no idea. So, last month, similar to today, I did a Fallout New Vegas marathon. The marathon lasted just as long as today's is going to last, like 7-8 hours of gameplay. Okay, and it was pretty fun. We had good progress in the game and all of that. Apparently, at the end of the stream, I was reading, I guess I had leveled up, and I was reading the different things I could do when you level up, like what are the options that I can get here or whatever. And I guess one of them was, oh, is that a star bottle cap? Hold on. It is, but, oh, there we go. Okay. One of the things that was there was like a bonus that if you get it, you get bonus limb damage. So when you do more damage to enemies, their limbs will cripple more easily and stuff like that. Okay. So apparently I'm reading this perk that you can get for leveling up in this very game. And I said bonus gem damage instead of bonus limb damage, okay? I guess it's documented. I haven't seen it, but apparently it's documented. I said it on the stream. So these people are like, you see? Phil said bonus gem damage after a marathon of Fallout New Vegas. That's obviously proof that he's playing mobile games with gems in them. Okay.
It kind of really just shows where your mind was at towards the end of the stream, which it's pretty solidified that after he's done playing whatever game he's playing, he's thinking about WWE Champions. He's making his way to playing WWE Champions. That's really more of the tell than anything. And if he had said what I had said, you know what I'm saying? He could try to explain that way a little bit better by being more direct on what the allegation is. Instead, Phil wants to stay with his own little narrative, knowing damn well it's not getting over. But he wants to stay with his own little narrative, so this way he doesn't give people any more of a reason to dissect it any further. He thinks he's being smart, but he's not.
Okay. Sure. Okay, if you say so. So do you see how this works? Do you see how this is just like a giant network of conspiracies that form this web, and the web becomes this weird belief that because there's all these conspiracies around that something is true. You see? No actual evidence of anything, but, well, we think that someone created a LINE chat account with Phil's cell phone number. We think that Phil said bonus, well, we know Phil said bonus gem damage on a stream. That's concrete evidence of everything we're saying over here. It's like, what? Anyway. What does it mean? Why is there a blue star under my bottle cap? Are the Reds behind this? Oh my god, it was a Sunset Zasparilla star bottle cap. Is this part of their mind control? They must be making me see things now, things that shouldn't be there. The star shouldn't be there. What do I see a star? It won't go away! Oh my god. Yo, they went nuts. They literally went nuts. Everyone in here went nuts. They believe that everything in this vault was some kind of crazy. Hey, you know what? This vault must be the vault of the people who think of all those conspiracy theories about me. It's about equivalent. The amount of crazy here is about on par with them, I would argue. Mmm. Yeah, there you go, too. Degasaur says, what about the conspiracy your wife moved out or that you're having a kid? Right, I mean, and then it's funny because when it's obvious these things aren't true, for example, when it's obvious I don't have a kid because, you know, you would probably hear the kid or, you know, it would make sense. I would have to watch the kid. How am I in here all day streaming if we have a kid, right? Like, someone has to watch the kids if they deal with the kid, right? So obviously it's not true, but then it just goes away. Oh, well, that one maybe wasn't so true, so we forget like...
Well, I don't know if that's actually gone away, but you mean like how you were hiding Jasper for all that time? And then you guys really weren't taking care of him because he ain't had two urinary tract infections. At least allegedly. So that's the first thing. Secondly, you do have this very strong compulsion or urge to keep your door closed, which doesn't mean a whole lot if Catherine is supposedly working all the time. And you could easily just put Jasper in another room and close that door. Just throwing it out there. I'm not saying anything about anything. I'm just saying it's really weird that we have a two-story house and we constantly have to keep his door closed. It's also even funnier, too, because before Catherine moved in, people used to tell him, hey, Phil, when are you going to clean up your office? Yada, 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 yada. Oh, the only time I have to do it is at night and I can't vacuum in my room or I can't vacuum my office because it'll disturb my neighbors and they'll report me. But yet he's admitted that Catherine would clean the bathrooms or vacuum other rooms at night and you could hear it. You could clearly hear it. And he was like, oh, she's probably just doing that. You know, she had a pretty early day today, so she feels the need to go ahead and clean up right now. You know, it's no big deal. So it's funny how it was no problem for Catherine to do all that stuff, but he couldn't do it. You know what I'm saying? He lies about the dumbest crap because, well, he has a dumb piece of crap.
And, you know, forget the fact that every conspiracy is wrong. We'll just pretend, you know, that their other ones are truthful, while that one we'll forget like we ever mentioned it. That's how these people are. Can I talk about Raid Shadow Legends, how much they wanted to give me? I don't remember off the top of my head, but I know it was like hundreds and hundreds of dollars. The way these opportunities work is you'll just get a random email to like your public address. For example, oh, I don't have the red key. I can't do this yet. I guess I have to go to the Sulfur Caves first. Okay, let me save up. I'll just get like a random email to my business email address and it'll be like, hey, it's an opportunity for a paid promotion campaign. You know, and then you'll read the email. It'll be like, hey, we saw your content and based on the content you put out and the amount of followers you have and the amount of views you get, we want to offer you a promotional campaign. And it'll be this amount of money and here's what it entails and blah, blah, blah. Okay. And usually the emails are very generic. A lot of the time, when you first get that email, it won't even say like what it's for. It literally will act like cryptic about what you're actually talking about. So I remember in particular with the Raid Shadow Legends one. This is a game that has been around for a very long time. It's a game that most people on the internet who do sponsorship end up doing the sponsorship because it's apparently lucrative. Like, they pay a lot. And a lot of people get offered it. Like, everyone gets offered this sponsorship for some odd reason, if you can believe it. Like, I don't know why, but I guess this company just has so much money to throw around. And they really just want to make money on their game so badly that they pay every single person who's a content creator on the internet to advertise their game. Now, you guys know me, right? I'm not going to just take a paid sponsorship without good reason. If it's a game I'm already playing and I'm liking, or product that I'll actually stand behind, then I'll consider doing a paid sponsorship. But 9 times out of 10, that's not the case. It ends up being something I'm not interested in. I wouldn't do it, right? But in this case, people who do the Raid Shadow Legends promotion usually end up getting seen in a pretty negative light because...
Okay, that doesn't make any sense either which way. Here's the reality of it all, ladies and gentlemen. He probably didn't get offered a whole lot. Now, the Raid Shadow Legends situation is nothing new, but what is, and how much people make is nothing new, because some people are actually pretty honest about it. There's a couple of gaming YouTubers that I watch, and each one of them have taken the deal, and each one of them have gotten... the amounts have varied quite a bit. Like one of them, I won't name them, but one person was offered 10 grand. Another one was said they were offered like 5,500 and two or three others were offered a couple of grand each. He said a couple of hundred. I don't think I've heard anybody say anything that low. I don't think. Cause I think even when It's a Gundam was approached with it, they offered him more than that. I'm pretty sure, but don't hold me to that. I mean, I don't hold me to that. That's kind of the lowest I've ever heard. When I've heard people being offered Raid Shadow Legends, I've heard at least 1,000 or over. I've never heard anybody being offered a deal in the hundreds, but that doesn't mean it doesn't happen. Here's the reality of it all. He's sitting here saying, oh, well, they offer all this money to all these people, and I don't understand why. I don't understand why they're just giving all this free money away. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But most people who do it are looked at in a negative light. how does that have any bearing or effect on you? You're considered, for all intents and purposes, a joke in the FG, and not in the FGC. Well, yes, in the FGC, but in gaming in general. He's looked at as the worst of the worst. You're looked at as the prime example of what not to be. Some people even put him on the level of some of those gamers out there, these big gamers who end up being pedophiles and groomers and shit. Some people put him on that level. Some people believe he's actually below them. With that being said, what the fuck do you care if your name is linked to Raid Shadow Legends? Collect your couple hundred dollars a month and move the fuck on with it. You're already addicted to mobile games anyway, so who gives a shit what the title of it is? Is he waiting for a WWE Champions endorsement? There are a lot of guys who play WWE Champions online who either stream it or make videos for it. I don't know if any of them are getting any endorsements or anything, but there's certainly a lot of them that do it and they all get a lot of views. So who gives a shit? You're worrying about, or if he's really sitting here thinking about his public persona, that just gives you an idea of how delusional this piece of garbage really is. Trying to salvage something that's already gone and done. If Wings was offered Raid Shadow Legends, I bet you he'd do it. Because why the fuck wouldn't he? Make yourself a 30-second or a minute ad, right? And just insert that shit in the beginning of all your fucking videos or every other video or whatever the case may be and move the fuck on. There ain't no morals to this shit. You think, or he thinks, I should say, him doing Raid Shadow Legends is so bad, it's so terrible to be associated with them, that he would rather come up here and beg day in, day out. He thinks that's a positive equivalent to him getting an endorsement with Raid Shadow Legends. Let that sink in. Let that sink in.
Done. And essentially, it's a total sellout deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, for example, people have told me about it on stream before I was offered this thing.
What do you mean, a fucking example? Aren't you the one who's saying that you wish you could do better for your family? There are plenty of men and women who have to work jobs that they feel that they shouldn't have to, or they believe that's beneath them, and it might actually be, but they do what they have to do to put money put food on the plate, if you will. Right? To keep the lights on and to keep a roof over their head. But this idiot right here doesn't want to do Raid Shadow Legends because what, ladies and gentlemen? Because just like I told you, he'll put his ego over money. I know a lot of people say it's the other way around, but and that's fine. Everybody's entitled to their own opinion. But the reality is, he will put his own ego over money. And it's not pride. He doesn't have any. It's ego. He will sure as hell put ego over money. He's doing it basically right here. Because it's funny how we were able to shit on people back in the day when he was making a lot of money on YouTube, and all those people who were begging on stream and accepting this and accepting that, those guys are fucking sellouts. Those guys are full of shit. But then years later, he's forced to do it, or he does it, I should say. Oh, I was forced to do it. Oh, YouTube ad revenue got so bad that I had no choice but to do it. Well, why would I still want to support you, Phil? Because you called all these people sellouts years ago. Why would I want to support you with that now? Because I really need the help. Well, how do you know those people didn't need the help? Well, look at all their views, man. Those guys are making more money than me. Well, yeah, but though you were living by yourself, or you were only worried about yourself, most of those people were supporting their families. Most of those people were putting their siblings through school. Most of those people were paying for medical treatments for their families and shit. If you actually watched any of their videos, you would know some of that shit. My circumstances have changed and I really need the help. That's something he's been caught saying. If that's not being a hypocrite, I don't know what is.
People have talked to me about it and said, you know, these YouTubers who I don't know, I always watch their content. All of a sudden, they're playing Raid Shadow Legends and doing a promotional video for Raid Shadow Legends. You know, they don't play the game. They're just doing it for a paycheck, right? So, yeah. And it's just silly because I'm not gonna stand by or advertise something that I don't actually believe in. If I'm playing a game and I'm checking it out for the first time and I'm told, hey, if you play this game and you don't like it, you can say it. Then, all right, great. But I'm not going to do a sponsorship where it's like, well, You're just paid to kiss the game's butt for a certain amount of time and do a promotional video or whatever. I wouldn't do that. You guys know that. I'm not a shill. I've never been like that at all. Any sponsorships I've done over the years, I'm honest. When I did the Loot Crate sponsorship, I told you very matter-of-factly if I liked what was actually in the Loot Crate or not. And sometimes I didn't. And I get the feeling that over time, that's why people didn't really buy the Loot Crates from my associate link. And that's why eventually I was removed from the program, right? You know, the things that I do are few and far between. But I'm not, Raid Shadow Legends, I've seen ads for it before, because just because it's a game that's so advertised heavily on the internet, just watching like YouTube videos and things, you see Raid Shadow Legends ads pop up and shit. The game looks bad. The game does not look very good. It looks like one of those games where it's all microtransactions to really advance. It's too grindy otherwise. And I would not, unless I actually played it and said, oh, I really like it, now I'll do it. But I wasn't going to accept any kind of a paid sponsorship for something that I know is not very good and I don't stand by. So it was funny because I remember getting the email and the guy's like, hey, I work for some company, some promotional company. I got a campaign for you I want to offer you based on the size of your channel and the amount of views you get. And basically what you have to do is play the game, do a promotional video of the game, talk about the game a certain amount of times, blah, blah, blah. All that, like, there's criteria, right, to qualify with it, right? So I was like, well, I mean, I didn't know what the game was. And I went back to them and I was like, well, if you could tell me what the game is and you know, the pay, I'd be interested to at least find out. And he came back and says, all right, well, it's Raid Shadow Legends. What's funny is he didn't tell me up front. I get the feeling that he purposely doesn't do that. Like, they hide that because so many people have done Raid Shadow Legends promotions.
Wait, let's go back and hear that. Because he was like, oh, well, can you tell me what the game is? Oh, and tell me what the pay is. So it kind of makes it sound like if the pay was good enough, it wouldn't have mattered what the game was. That's what it sounds like. If he was really concerned about just the game itself, oh, well, could you tell me what the game is? He wanted to know about the game and the pay. Let's go back and listen to it.
A campaign for you I want to offer you based on the size of your channel and the amount of views you get. And basically, what you have to do is play the game, do a promotional video of the game, talk about the game a certain amount of times, blah, blah, blah. All that. Like, there's criteria, right, to qualify with it, right? So I was like, well, I mean, I didn't know what the game was. And I went back to them and I was like, well, if you could tell me what the game is and you know, the pay, I'd be interested to at least find out. And he came back and says, all right, well, it's Raid Shadow Legends. What's funny is he didn't tell me up front. I get the feeling that he purposely doesn't do that. Like, they hide that because so many people have done Raid Shadow Legends promotions that they don't want to just say it up front. So he's like, well, it's Raid Shadow Legends and it was this much. And I don't remember how much, but I just remember it was like a lot of money. Like, I don't think it was like $1,000. But I remember it being like hundreds and hundreds of dollars. And I was like, damn, you know, that. Think about that. Every YouTuber who did this made that much money and a complete 100% sellout. Because how many people were streaming?
Because like I said, I have not heard people doing Raid Shadow Legends or being offered hundreds of dollars. I've heard them being offered thousands of dollars, tens of thousands of dollars, but not hundreds. So that's scraps for you, I suppose. But the fact that he was like, the game and the pay is really what the giveaway is. That's really what it was. And I bet you anything, he tried to email them back and say, well, if you could bump the pay up to this here, then we can work, we can do something. And they were probably like, we don't really feel the need to do that. This isn't beggars can't be choosers, Phil. There's you yourself have already said they offer deals to everybody. You're not worthy of that big money. You're not worth that big money. And that's why you weren't offered it.
YouTubers, you really think, went on to fucking play that game. You know? They did it 100% for the paycheck. And that's the kind of stuff that I won't do. I'm telling you guys, like, that's the kind of stuff that I'm not all about. I'm not going to be doing a paid promotion just to take the pay. Listen.
If that was really the case, he wouldn't have even asked how much the money was then. He would have been like, what's the game again? Okay, let me think about it. But he wanted to know the game and how much. So it's amazing how you have a sellout here having the nerve to criticize other sellouts when, if the money was big enough, he would have sold out.
That could help me tremendously to do that kind of stuff.
Because remember, as a man, he's trying to do the best he can for his family. He's trying to do everything that's in his power for his family, to provide for them. But yet, for some reason, our ego keeps getting in the way, right? Right? Right.
From indie games I never heard of, from a studio like that, from mobile games I'm not going to play. I won't do it. Listen, I'm crowdfunded. That means you like what I do. I put out content based on that you like, and you support it. That's my model. Not take every fucking paycheck under the sun, all right? Just because I can make money doing it. And seriously, if you take a look at the people who do it, you got to look at them with a grain of salt and say, gee, maybe the reason they're really doing content is to take the paycheck, not because they love what they're doing, and they're doing it for any kind of meaning, you know?
And this ass clown right here then decides to go ahead and shit on his peers, which is something he did on Twitch. It's something he did on YouTube back in the day. He used to sit there and get mad at these people who were making all this money, beating him out all day. And he was like, you shouldn't be supporting those people because they're only doing it for the money. You know what I'm saying? They already have large followings. They already have these huge productions and everything and all these people working behind them. They're only doing it for a paycheck. They're not doing it because they love the game. Or these streamers out here, they're only... Why would you give hundreds of dollars to people who are already rich? What sense does that make? They already got paid. Most of them are already in guaranteed deals. You need to support the smaller streamers because they're doing it because they love it, not because they're trying to collect a paycheck. That's what he said. While this idiot's collecting $100,000 a year himself. Begging, of course, but still.
There's characters of Raid Shadow Legends that are content creators. They are. They're content creators who took a ginormous paycheck, probably tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars, to have their character in the game. These people are already rich. They already are millionaires. Why do they need to take a paycheck to have their character in Raid Shadow Legends, a game that they don't play and never will do anything in? Right?
Thanks, Phil, for proving my point yet again. Just in case anybody had any doubt. Here, let's bring it back for clarification's sake. That's a good screenshot too. Miserable piece of shit.
That's my model. Not take every fucking paycheck under the sun, all right? Just because I can make money doing it. And seriously, if you take a look at the people who do it, you got to look at them with a grain of salt and say, gee, maybe the reason they're really doing content is to take the paycheck, not because they love what they're doing and they're doing it for any kind of meaning, you know? There's characters of Raid Shadow Legends that are content creators. They are. They're content creators who took a ginormous paycheck, probably tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars, to have their character in the game. These people are already rich. They already are millionaires. Why do they need to take a paycheck to have their character in Raid Shadow Legends, a game that they don't play and never will do anything in? Right? I don't want to be a part of that. I don't want to be a part of that. I've always told you guys that I'm different from everyone else. I'm not going to take that easy paycheck. I'm going to say I will put out meaningful content and earn it. All right? That's the kind of guy I am.
Begging is not an easy paycheck? You begging is earning it? I mean, so if for all you guys who like say he has pride, so his pride does have a cost. Does that not make him a sellout then? Because he's too lazy or too stupid to actually put in the work to be entertaining and chooses begging as a way out? Just asking.
So guys, we've got about an hour and a half left on today's stream. Again, my last appeal to you, if you guys could help me out by tipping, I would appreciate it. I'm trying to raise as much as I can to pay my bills at this point, unless a miracle happens in the next hour and a half. Yeah. Looks like I'm not paying my mortgage this weekend and there's nothing I can do about it. But it's still gonna help, trust me. Any support you're lending is going to help me. Whether or not I can do the mortgage or not, it will still help, so.
That's good.
I'm gonna save up. Last hour to hour and 15 minutes, I'll probably be playing for around 8 p.m., okay, guys? Again, I want to say thank you to those who did chill with me and those who supported. In fact, you guys don't know, but it's like, between memberships and super chats, the behind the scenes, it's not really behind the scenes, but you know what I'm saying, it's not on the leaderboard. That support was really good today, and that's going to help me come September, so thank you for that. It's a shame that we're not even coming close to this tip skull, and, you know, at this point, I'm not even going
to... Well, it's nice to hear that behind the scenes or silent majority money is still kicking through. Just, you know, I mean, he's the one who admitted it, not me.
I'm going to save up. Last hour to hour and 15 minutes, I'll probably be playing till around 8 p.m. Okay, guys? Again, I want to say thank you to those who did chill with me and those who supported. In fact, you guys don't know, but it's like between memberships and super chats, the behind the scenes, it's not really behind the scenes, but you know what I'm saying? It's not on the leaderboard. That support was really good today, and that's going to help me come September. So thank you for that. It's a shame that we're not even coming close to this tip skull. And, you know, at this point, I'm not going to worry about it anymore because I'm just not going to pay the mortgage. I'll have to wait for my YouTube payment to come through to pay it. And if they contact me about why it was late, I'll be honest with them. I'll say, hey, I had a change of income because now I get paid at a different time of the month. And I can't
pay. Wait, we're in August and you're talking about being late on a payment? Let me bring that back. Listen, what is this again? This video was August. This was taken from August. This was August 14th. Video was published on the 15th. And you're talking about being late on a mortgage payment. Huh, okay. Oh, was this the fundraiser thing, though? That might explain it. That shit was a failure either which way.
It's not really behind the scenes, but you know what I'm saying? It's not on the leaderboard. That support was really good today, and that's going to help me come September. So thank you for that. It's a shame that we're not even coming close to this tip skull. And, you know, at this point, I'm not going to worry about it anymore because I'm just not going to pay the mortgage. I'll have to wait for my YouTube payment to come through to pay it. And if they contact me about why it was late, I'll be honest with them. I'll say, hey, I had a change of income because now I get paid at a different time of the month. And I can't pay it this early anymore and see if maybe they'll work with me. I don't know. I have no idea what's going to happen. I guess we'll find out. All right. But it is what it is. I do want to say thank you to those who did contribute. I appreciate that. And it will still help. Don't get me wrong. It just sucks that I can't immediately do what I needed to do with that money. But it is what it is. All right. And I do appreciate that very much. All right. All right, Mean Master. Enjoy your time out for spamming all the Nightbot commands. And if you come back and do it again, I'm just going to ban you. Very nice. Proteus Ashes at a $10 super chat says, as someone who lost their house in a 2009 financial crisis, you're about to miss your mortgage payment. There's zero panic from you. It seems odd. Explain and I'll donate $50. Sure. Sure. So my mortgage payment is due tomorrow. All right? So technically, it's not supposed to be due till Monday because it's Sunday. They're not going to get the payment tomorrow anyway, even if I were to process it. All right? If I had no money for this payment at all for the rest of this month, and it was going to be like weeks to a month late, yeah, then I'd be panicking because I'd be like, you know it's going to happen. They're going to contact me. They're going to say, hey, is this going to be an ongoing thing? There's going to be late fees. Likely they're going to try to, if this were ongoing, they would go to the point where they were probably looking to foreclosure and stuff like that. But that takes a while. That takes months and months. I would have to be like, if I can't pay my mortgage for like 6 to 8 months, then maybe they look into it. Okay? This is just... like, it'll be about a week to 2 weeks, maybe, right? Because what's going to happen is, I'm not going to pay it. Now, I can't. I don't have enough. I needed a lot more today in order to pay it, and I can't. So, I'm not going to pay it.
So, I don't even know if they're going to... Keep in mind, we had a day off before this where we went out and spent to our heart's content, right? We did that for at least the past 3 weeks leading up to this. Couldn't put those hundreds of dollars, you know, that he spent. That couldn't have gone to saving up for our mortgage. Who knows what he spent on frivolous bullshit between that period of time, between his last YouTube paycheck and this current one, you're just going to take the L. I thought he was supposed to be trying to do anything and everything he can for his family. And we've gotten to the point where our addiction to fucking a mobile game is trumping even paying fucking our mortgage. And in his head, and as he just said, hey, it'll be like 6 to 8 months until it really becomes an issue. So he's kind of already building up in his own head, hey, maybe if I decide to go ahead and not pay the mortgage for 1 month, and then I have to double up the following month, hey, it's all right because it'll only be a month late. And so, you know, I'll take some fees or whatever, but eventually it'll get done. He's kind of already justifying in his own mind, I have that much wiggle room if I need it. This is becoming a fucking problem. That's what this shit is. This is becoming a fucking problem. It's been a problem. But now we're talking about skimming out on the mortgage now? We're talking about skimping the mortgage for 2 weeks? 2 weeks can easily turn into a month, ladies and gentlemen. A month can turn into 3 months as long as he doesn't, I mean, I'm guessing, because I don't know what it's like not to pay my bills. But as long as he doesn't end up at the 4 to 6 month range where he owes that much money, he probably thinks, hey, I'll be all right. Boy, if he don't get back on Twitch, if he don't get back on Twitch, and if YouTube does not implement a gifted membership type scenario, shit's gonna get rough. Because clearly, his addiction, his personal indulgence, trumps our obligations, which is the reason why he filed for bankruptcy in the first place. Shit's about to get bad. Like I said, October 20th, 21st, if we don't hear him getting back into that partnership, boy, YouTube better come in on the clutch.
Contact me this week or not about it. But when I do get my payment from YouTube on the 21st, that's the first thing I'll pay. You know, everything, like right now, what do I have to pay this coming week? My utilities. If I don't pay that, they will turn off the electricity. They will turn off the water. They'll turn that stuff off if you don't pay it. So that's a necessity, you know. I have to go grocery shopping on Tuesday. Those are things that I have to spend money on this week. If I had all the money for the mortgage, I would do that too. But I don't now. So I'll pay all the other necessities this week. And when I get paid by YouTube in the coming week, then I'll pay the mortgage. And it'll be late. And they'll charge me late fees. And I don't know. What I'm hoping is that this is not going to be an ongoing thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm hoping.
Now, here's another thing too. You're telling me Catherine can't float him for a little bit just to avoid the fees? You're telling me Catherine can't float him? Or maybe Catherine's smart too and is like, yeah, if I loan you money, there's probably no guarantee I'll get it back. So I don't think I'm up on that job. I don't think I feel like that's an obligation that I need to be doing. This is pretty sus. This is pretty fucking sus.
The increase in attendance and the increase in support that I'm getting on these streams from the YouTube side, and that means things like memberships and super chats, it's going to be enough to be equivalent or getting closer to being equivalent to what things were on Twitch. It's going to take a while. I know it is, but over the next couple of months, there'll be more newer games. There'll be more people coming to the streams to watch me watch, play the new releases and the like. And I'm just going to stick with it. And hopefully this is not an ongoing thing every month. This will be the first time since I've been with this company that I have a late payment and there's nothing I can do about it. So we'll see what happens, right? Why would I exactly be freaking out? Like, oh my God, crying on the stream for one thing, right? So, you know what I mean? Like, I know it'll happen. They're going to probably charge me a late fee. It's the first time it's ever happened, so likely it's not going to be a big deal. If, like I said, if you're chronically a late payer on a bill, that's a problem. But, you know, it's not a ginormous issue to only be a little bit late on a payment, especially because, like I said, I know I'm getting paid by YouTube on the 21st. I'll be able to pay it then, you know? So there you go. Let's see here. So there you go. That was, what was his name again? Proteus Ash? There's your explanation. Proteus Ash. There's your explanation. When you're an adult, all right? When you're an adult, you don't panic about every little thing. You don't. Today, absolutely, it would have been amazing if I could have rallied and made enough to make the payment. Then
Being able to pay your mortgage on time is a little thing? I don't know, man. That doesn't sound like a little thing to me. He says it's bad to be chronically late on your bills, but we've clearly, he's told us, because you can go back and find it, that he said that I've been late on my bills before. I don't think he's ever came out and said that his mortgage was going to be late. He's threatened that if people don't give him money, his mortgage will be late. But I don't think he's ever come out and said it's actually going to be late. Or it was late. But this is a problem. This mindset is a problem. Because this is what got him fucked over with them credit cards. Oh, I can't pay the minimum balance because the minimum balance is like 200 something fucking dollars or whatever. Oh, well, I'm just going to skip this payment. I'll pay what I can next month then. Oh, well, I don't have the money. I'm sorry. I don't have it. So, you know, you have to wait till I get it. And so on and so forth. And then shit ballooned up to the point where he just couldn't make minimum monthly payments. But yet we kept charging on those cards, though. We didn't mind doing that. Unless the credit card companies were like, whoa, he owes us a shitload of money. Yo, cut the card to where he can't spend nothing and he really needs to start paying us back. Damn.
About late fees or nothing or any kind of issue. But I also know that when you miss one payment, you don't lose your house. You know, nor did I ever say anything to that effect. So
that's not true. You go back to the Save Your House marathons back in 2017, 2018. He made it sound just like that. Hey, if you guys don't help me pay my mortgage this month, I'm gonna lose my fucking house. Just throwing it out there.
Super chat. Yeah, and yeah, you owe me $50 because I explained it.
Oh, dude.
Been shooting with her. Yeah, so he didn't pay me 50. He was a liar. I knew it. He didn't do shit. Would have felt guilty to part. Okay. Get rid of another idiot. Chili Dog. Give me $4.20. So what would it take for me to make serious changes to content and streams? Okay. Like what? Because he says sometimes people give you advice and you ignore it or you turn it down. Improving your stream quality will increase viewers. I mean, what exactly would you like me to do with the limitations that I have? The things that people ask me to do a lot of the times are things that are just not reasonable. Like, okay, use a green screen. Okay, right now I could go get a green screen. It would look terrible. Why? Because my webcam is terrible. Right? My webcam is not great quality. So if you put a green screen behind me, it doesn't matter. It's still going to look bad. It's going to look pixelated. It's going to look blurry. It's not going to look good. So then you say, okay, well then upgrade your webcam. All right. So now I got to go spend money on a webcam or whatever. Fair enough. But since I moved from Twitch to YouTube, right, I upped my stream quality. Now every single stream is 1080p, 60 frames per second. In some cases, like me staring at Raul, just staring back at me creepily, it's not a big deal. Right now, I'm looking at my CPU use, and it says it's roughly 30-31%, because there's nothing going on the screen right now. But in particular, in regards to games that are full of action, or games where there's a lot going on, my CPU is pushing 80-90% most of the time. This computer that I have is over 7 years old. It's at a point where it's, you know, I'm doing the most I can possibly do with it. It's not going to be able to do anything. If I bought a better webcam right now, in fact, this webcam right now I'm using does 1080p. But years ago, I actually had this webcam at a higher quality. And when I had it at the 1080p and I was doing it with 1080p video, my stream would chop up. And people would say to me, why is it going on? I was like, oh, I think it's the camera. And then what happened is I would lower the camera quality and then everything worked. Because it's too much. My computer is old, man. It's old. Do you want to see better webcam, green screen, all that? Great. I need a new PC, and we got to get to that point. Right now is not the time for that stuff. I'm about to enter the best, busiest gaming season.
People were requesting that from him. Sorry about that. When he bought the new PC, and he still said he couldn't do it, or he didn't want to do it. One thing at a time. I'm already doing this. I already got the new PC. I already got the sound foam and everything like that. You know, we'll build up to it. Never happened. All these years later, now all of a sudden, oh, I need a new PC for that. Keep in mind, the same PC, right, that is on all day, every day, for the last 6 or 7 years. He's never turned that computer off. Keep that in mind. Same thing with that laptop. I don't think he turned, especially the new one, he probably doesn't turn it off. I would hope he'd probably be smart enough to put it in sleep mode or something, but he never turned off that PC. I'm surprised it never burned out on him. Even for a lemon, I'll give him that, or I'll give it that.
Equipment that's going to be here working every day, not me trying to learn something new on the fly right when I need to be here every day for all the big releases, right? Right now is one of the worst times to buy computers. Components are monstrously overpriced, very hard, scare, you know, big scarcity right now because of COVID and everything. This is probably one of the worst times that you could possibly want to buy a new PC. Okay? So, that being said, the things that people recommend for upgrades, I hear you, I understand. Listen, I wanted upgrades for a while. Just take a look at the three upgrades that just happened because of very generous fans. The Xbox Series X, we've been playing on for 2 weeks straight and played so many awesome games and fun things because of it. Huge improvement. Thank you to the fan who donated that because you made that possible. This new laptop that now I can monitor with all you guys. I can actually read your stream chat. It's not crashing. We're not sitting here waiting for me to reload it or anything else. It's constant content now for you guys with zero interruption. That's amazing. Thank you to the fan for that. This chair, are you shitting me? Guys, this is the second week in a row I'm doing a marathon. Previously, before I had this chair, I would be sore just from sitting with no back support for a few hours. Now I'm sitting here 2 weekends in a row, I did a marathon and I'm good. Like right now, I stand up, my feet feel a little tired, a little stiff, but I feel good. My back has zero pain. Zero. Zero. This is amazing, right? This is tons of improvement because you guys have helped me out so much this year, all right? And I appreciate that, but understand something. You know, there are limitations to what can happen. And right now is not the time to be trying to upgrade a PC in the midst of the busiest time of the gaming year that we're about to hit. I need consistency. I got to be here every day. I got to cover all the hot games. I got to put out the good streams for you guys, period. Maybe when things start to slow down next year, right? When we look at like earlier next year, there's not a lot coming out or whatever. Then maybe we could consider
upgrading. Do you not know what it means to be consistent then? If you can't do it now, what makes you think that you'll be able to do it later on down the line? That doesn't make any sense at all. You plan on taking extra days off at the beginning of the year? No. So why do you not understand what consistency means? I'm very confused on how all this is supposed to play out. Very, very confused. And yet again, this is present Phil trying to put off the responsibility on future Phil. And that's why future Phil always gets fucked. But see, future Phil needs to constantly be fucked so he can continue to keep moving forward. And that's essentially the narrative. That's the scenario. He's never going to get better because the moment he starts getting better, he's scared that people won't continue to support him. He has to constantly be in, dire straits just to keep the contributions coming in. So this narrative of being a waiter or a bartender or any of those things is bullshit. It's absolute bullshit. It's begging for the sake of begging. It's begging and constantly being in dire straits, being in peril, you know, always having a new calamity to keep things going. It's amazing how this all happens. And how can you justify that it's not begging? You don't do anything else. You being here for the hot new releases don't mean shit. You don't draw the numbers that you used to for that, whether on stream or on YouTube. Whether on stream or whether the VOD later on down the line. At the end of the day, you lost. If you want to keep doing this, go ahead, but you lost.
Improvements to it. This point, this is the worst possible time, seriously. So here we go again. He tipped again and says, your content needs to change. You need to change your on-stream behaviors. I've been watching for a long time. These are not unreasonable suggestions. Pre-streaming breaks need to change. Stream schedule and chosen games. These don't cost money. Stream schedule and chosen games. You mean how in the last month, since I could now do it, I'm playing everything on Game Pass according to what you guys want. Like, I directly listened to what you wanted. We did Game Pass interactive streams where you guys picked games for me to play, and that's what I'm doing now? Is that what you mean? Okay, so no pre-streaming, no breaks ever. Just sit here for hours on end and not take any breaks and feel like shit. All right, so how about this? Here's what we're going to do, all right? If you have intelligent...
But you've complained plenty of times of feeling like shit because you didn't get the money that you feel that you need. You've been caught yawning. You've been caught nodding off, essentially, on stream before. Multiple times. During multiple streams. So trust me, you seem like you feel like shit either which way. You clearly don't like doing this. You're not passionate about shit. The money is the driving force. And then once you have it, you used to be prone to just leaving early. Okay, guys, I'm just going to cut it off early. We hit the tips goal. I'm good. I'll see you guys tomorrow. See, that's why he can't get a real job. That's he can't have real responsibility on him. Look at the responsibility that he already is obligated to, and he can barely fulfill that. You expect him to do anything else and actually have like a time frame to do it? Like, you know what I'm saying? To be on an actual schedule to do it? He wouldn't be able to.
Give them to me. I am open to all intelligent, reasonable suggestions. But if you're someone who's entitled and feels that if you give a suggestion and that suggestion does not get implemented, that you're going to be butthurt about it, then don't give a suggestion. Because if I have a perfectly reasonable explanation for why it's not feasible or why I can't do a change immediately, and you're going to be all upset, oh my God, Phil didn't directly listen to exactly what I said and immediately change. Is this your stream? Exactly. Here's what you do. Start up your own stream and do your own thing. And I will wish you the best. I hope that you have success with what you do. But there's a reason why I do what I do. It's all justified. The regulars here don't complain. It seems to be these outsiders who come in. Well,
the regulars are the silent majority more often than not. But you would wish them the best, right? You mean like how you did with Tevin? Like that? And now you don't even want to bring him up because he's over there on Twitch and he's doing incredibly well. And I think one of the reasons why you keep Tevin out your mouth, which you should be doing anyway, is because you're hoping that you can get back over there and you don't want to do anything to piss off a partner. And then if they don't let you back into the partnership program, which I don't think they will, and even if they did, you'd have to wait like a year for that anyway, and they put him back in as an affiliate, he definitely is not going to say anything because he definitely doesn't want that ire on him for any little thing. Twitch is slowly but surely changing, and changing in a big way. And the Twitch that he left is not going to be the same Twitch that he goes back to. We'll see. we'll see. I should start a stream over there, by the way.
Oh, why is he doing a pre-stream? My God, Phil took a break today? Yeah, a break during a fucking marathon stream. By the way, my breaks today were actually shorter than the breaks that I usually take during my regular streams. They were significantly shorter. But this guy is literally complaining about bullshit. So if you're going to nitpick about bullshit and not be happy when I don't change my entire stream style for your little nitpicky requests, either say, okay, whatever, or move on. Don't sit here butthurt. No one wants to hear you airing your butthurt gripe grievances. Seriously. Okay. Thanks for the tips, by the way. All right. Oh my God. This is the last time I'm going to address stupidity. Mouth Drew and Moron does a super chat. He says, why did I do a fundraiser marathon if it's not urgent? Because it is. The point is, if we had hit the goal today, I would have been in the clear and paid the mortgage. I would have been able to pay my utilities this week. Everything would have been good. And I would have been able to rest easy and be like, no big deal. Now I'm going to be behind on payments.
That's not true. He would have just came back the next day and begged all over again. And everybody knows it. And that's one of the reasons why he didn't hit the goal.
Things are going to start to compile badly. All right? But when you're an adult, you don't just incredibly go to panic mode before you get to the bad part. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would have liked to do really well today and get everything done, but it didn't happen. Why are we going to sit here and freak out, right? like, what do you want me to do?
Yes, because it's being a mature adult to sit on your fucking ass and play games poorly and just demand people to give you the money you need. That's being a mature adult. Makes sense. Makes a whole lot of sense. Jesus Christ. I've seen, what's that dude's name? King Cobra? I've seen that dude come really fucking close to being evicted out of his place, and he don't even act like this. Holy shit.
To hear it cry because this happened. No, people were very generous today. Like I said, super chats are actually really good today. Tips are really good today, right? So I'm not going to sit here and be upset when my fans came out and rallied and supported me today. We couldn't hit the amount that I needed, but that's not their fault. So I'm not going to sit here and freak out about it and be sad or be upset about that at all. You know, I'm just going to say, well, it is what it is. And move on positively like I always do, right? It's not that I didn't need to do this today. Absolutely, I needed to do this today. I needed to see if I could make happen the best case scenario. Now we move on to not so good scenarios, but it's still not panic mode, end of the world shit. But if you're a child and you don't understand that because you're not an adult who's been through this stuff before, you wouldn't understand at all. You see the world as black or white. It was either Phil raised it or he doesn't. If he raises it, it's good. If he can't raise it, it's terrible. End of the world. No. No. And this will help. What we raise today will help because this concretely will help me pay the utilities at the very least in the next week that have to be paid. Right? So at least that will be done. It's partially what I needed to do. It's not everything I needed to do, but it's still a good start. You see? So
even though in actuality, because he didn't hit the goal, he just told us this, because he didn't hit the goal, he's going to be at a deficit because he's not going to be able to pay his mortgage on time, and he's going to get hit with all those fees, which he's going to end up begging for the following week and the week after that and the week after that. It's a really weird way of trying to keep yourself in a constant state of peril, but that's the pig Fuhrer's way, I guess. Broke back pig. Financial problems.
So stupid.
No. Broke back Brunel. That's what I should have gone with. That sounds better.
Of course they don't. Not only do these people not know how normal human bills work, they don't even know how life works. I seriously, like, these people.
Did you just say normal human bills? What? God damn, you talk like a fucking Martian. Jesus Christ.
So stupid. No, of course they don't. Not only do these people not know how normal human bills work, they don't even know how life works. I seriously, like, these people are so, their way of thinking is such a simpleton mindset. Like, I don't understand why you did a fundraiser marathon if you weren't going to lose your house. What? Let me ask you a question about this, all right? Why would you do that the moment you're going to lose your house? Right? Why would you wait? Why would you wait?
Well, that question could be posed to you. If you knew your mortgage was due tomorrow, Monday, if you want to argue semantics, why would you wait till the day before to do a fundraiser to raise the money? Why would you wait till Saturday to fucking do the fundraiser? Why didn't you just do the fundraiser Wednesday or Thursday? And if you didn't hit it, you still had two more days to get the money up. So why don't you go ahead and turn that question around and pose that to yourself, dumbass? That's pushing the goalpost. That's pushing the goalpost back. Oh, why would I want to wait till I lost my house or I'm losing my house? Why the fuck would you wait until the day before the damn thing is due? That's a better question.
Wouldn't you try to do something to prevent the worst case scenario before it happens? Which is what I'm doing. Like, I mean, again, this is common sense to people, but not to you. So I guess your name might be appropriate. I don't know what else to say, man. I'm not even going to answer his nonsense anymore because he's still doing super chats. I'm going to say whatever. He's so stupid. Jeez, man. Here's what you should do. If you have any questions about what took place today, go ask a parent or ask an adult, a responsible adult who actually has life responsibilities unlike you. They'll answer all your questions for you. I promise you, they'll actually be able to answer these important things for you. But I'm not
good job, Phil. Good job for admitting that you're none of those things, and that's why they need to ask someone else. Very good job, Phil. I'm glad that for once, some self-awareness stepped in. That was some good advice, Phil. You know what I'm saying? That's some good advice. Don't ask the barely shaved monkey that you're sitting here watching now. Go ahead and ask someone who actually knows what the fuck they're doing. You know, those responsible adults who aren't late on their bills. Those responsible adults who put money away or to the side to make sure that their bills are paid. You know, those people who think they may come up short and they hustle a little more to make sure they got that money up, to make sure their bills are squared away. Yes, those responsible adults. Ask them why you have to do certain things. Don't pose that shit to me, because I don't fucking know. You're talking about a 40-year-old man who still has mommy and daddy send him money each and every month. So yeah, he's right. That was good advice. That was very fucking good advice. You guys should clap for him. You guys really should. I'm not going to do it, but you guys should. Just kidding, you don't have to do it. I wouldn't ask someone to fucking do something I wouldn't be willing to do myself. But that was good advice. That was damn good advice.
Yeah, I was going to say whatever. This is stupid. Jeez, man. Here's what you should do. If you have any questions about what took place today, go ask a parent or ask an adult, a responsible adult who actually has life responsibilities, unlike you. They'll answer all your questions for you. I promise you, they'll actually be able to answer these important things for you. But I'm not your dad, so I can't. I'm not going to answer these questions for you on my stream. Okay. All right. Let's continue. The smell. Oh, Flying Night Slasher now did a $5 super chat. Thank you very much. He says, I guess I didn't really understand you. I first saw you back on the This Is How You Don't Play Metal Gear Solid videos, and that was probably years ago. I mean, dude, are you kidding? That was like almost 10 years ago. Yeah. As you, I'm sure you've seen, what I do today is so different from what I used to do 10 years ago. And definitely the people who want to constantly talk shit about me will incredibly stretch the truth or essentially just make shit up about the kind of stuff that happens on my streams. Like, if you were here all day today just relaxing with me watching Fallout, you see, I was just having fun with the game, having a fun conversation with you guys. Did money even ever come up as a point of discussion? Not really. I didn't bring it up. Other people do. It's always someone else who wants to cause drama or do something, cause an issue for me, right? I'm just having fun, man. I'm just enjoying games, enjoying life, and having a good time with you guys. That's what it's about for me. But these people just want to constantly be harping on shit.
Yeah, that was actually a good call on Hate Army's part by showing what the title of the stream was. Oh, I didn't bring up anything about money. Did I say anything about money? It's in the fucking title. Semantics, though. Semantics, though.
Blender Bottle now did a super chat. It's a stream suggestion during breaks. Do jumping jacks on camera. Number of jumping jacks is the number of tips before the break. You get blood flow and stream gets content. No one needs to see a fucking grown man doing jumping jacks. It's a stupid suggestion. I'm sorry. It just is.
But it wasn't a problem, though, to do 25 push-ups in 25 seconds for what? It was $200 or whatever that was? That wasn't stupid, though. Right? Right? Right.
I got an idea. Why don't you just have me dress up in a chicken suit all month, right? Why not? Why not just have me cover my body in Crisco cooking grease and dress up like a chicken on stream all month? Doesn't that sound good?
Well, actually, you being a greasy pig seems a bit more fitting, being that that's already your natural state within your natural habitat. You are very greasy. That's clear because you don't bathe and you've admitted this. And, you know, you are a pig. A fat, greasy, disgusting fucking pig. So I feel like the pig one's a little bit better. That's just me, though.
Sounds like something that I should do, right? All right.
Oh, dude.
It's over already? Yeah, can you believe it? Dude, it's 8:03 p.m. Whenever I play this game, time flies. And like I said, because of this chair now, it didn't even matter that I played all day. I feel fine. I feel energized. I don't feel bad at all. Like, when I used to do marathons, I genuinely would feel like sore and in pain and exhausted by the end of the day. I don't feel that way anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, things are so much better now because of these upgrades I got this year, and I'm really appreciative of all that, guys. And I'm appreciative of all of you here today, chilled with me, for all of you who relaxed and have a good time with me in Fallout New Vegas today. Thank you, obviously, to everyone who contributed today. Yes, we did not hit the goal, but this will help tremendously. Like I said, this is enough. This will pay my utilities coming up this week. And at least put me in a much better position than I was, that's for sure. All right? And things are getting better. I mean, today, membership super chats were great on this marathon. They were really genuinely good. So if I can maintain that level of support moving forward, then hopefully I won't have to do marathons like this every month. You know, I'd like to do just regular streams like I do and have to worry so much about this shit, but we'll see what happens. All right, guys? All right, so excellent. Guys, thank you so much for your support. Great marathon today.
Oh, money, yeah. These contributions are mandatory. Money, yeah. Money. Oh, money.
See, here's the thing about Swaggins, or not Swaggins, or whatever the fuck. He's part of the reason why this shit actually is the way it is. He helped facilitate this shit on Twitch. So the fact that he's sitting here bitching about this shit now, kind of take your ass back on the porch. just take your ass back on the porch. You're one of the facilitators on why this shit happened the way it did. Don't sit there and bitch about this shit now. And then after he ain't shitted all over you during Resident Evil, or was it Sekiro, however you pronounce that. I can't remember what game it was that he publicly shitted all over you, and you smarten up and left, but then you end up crawling right back because that's what fucking weak ass people do. I can't remember the game. It doesn't even matter. If you really wanted to hold anything to anything, you would have just stepped away and that's it. The dude don't value you. The dude doesn't care about you. He don't respect you. You know what I'm saying? You don't have a right to complain. You really don't. I mean, if you want to do it, go ahead, but shit. And yes, misery does love company. That's a great quote, actually. Shit. Big ups to Hate Army Watch for this. That was fucking ridiculous, to say the very fucking least. Alright, give me a second to kind of square up and shit for a second, and we'll reconvene for final thoughts, and I will let you guys go on with your day. Oh, holy shit. Holy fucking shit. Wow. It's fucking amazing. So fucking amazing. Here we go. Christ, that was something special. Oh, that was a good touch, though. That was a very nice touch, I should say. Hate Army for the throwing the food bits in between. But nice touch, very nice touch. All right, guys. So, what are our thoughts? Didn't debunk shit. First off and foremost, didn't debunk anything. The food segments in between was funny, weird in the fact that how Phil. Just an awkward ass dude, man. He's his thinking, his actions, it's just very out there, man. It's very out there. I mean, I don't know if, you know what I'm saying? I've heard a lot of people in my time say that, you know what I'm saying, they've been a fucking Martian on this planet and shit. Like, I'm on Earth, but I'm not like you motherfuckers. I've heard plenty of people kind of come off and say shit like that. I get it. You know what I'm saying? But that's different. That is really, really, really fucking different when you put that into perspective. Didn't debunk shit. He made it worse. Clearly, it's what Phil does. The walls are just coming in on him. It's just closing in, and he doesn't have a way out, and he knows it. Holy shit, bro. And the thing is, though, too, is when he gets into situations like that, where he really starts to get desperate, that's when shit comes out. That's when shit starts to really hit the fucking fan. So anybody who's followed the detractor history or lore, they know this. So if any big things pop out, it'll be interesting to see what it is for whatever it is. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening in. I very much appreciate it. I will catch you guys in the next broadcast, whenever that may be. Take care of yourselves. Yet again, big ups to Hate Army Watch. Big ups to all of all my fellow detractors, all detractors in general. Big ups to all y'all. And Big ups to all you guys, you know what I'm saying, who are watching or viewing or listening, whatever the case may be. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you guys for the next one. Later, people. What does that mean? They send you a verification code? What does that mean?